So why is Allah saying to him the following ayah? Stay away, ya Muhammad, from idols.
You're supposed to be a follower of Jesus, and you're using words like that.
Well, it's not my words. It's not my words. It's the words of Allah. Are you embarrassed of Allah? Ladies and gentlemen, it's time! This is the moment that you all have been waiting for. We are live! Live. You are listening to the live broadcast of your friendly neighbor, stream doctor, and Christian apologist. The warrior for Christ and enemy of Allah and his messenger. This is your favorite YouTuber. Now, speaking from cave. Hira. Rob Christian. Please fasten your seatbelts. Houston, we are ready for takeoff. We are back, baby. We are live, baby. Let's go. Hello, everybody. God bless you. Nice to see you. Welcome, welcome. Hello, hello. Welcome, friends. Welcome, admins. Yes, you heard it correct. We are live, baby. Up by Franz, I welcome dear sister Chloe Waked. How are you? Chris Claus in the house. Welcome, my friend. God bless you. Guys, give my dear brother Chris Claus some love here. Subscribe to his YouTube channel. Nice to see you, brother. Phil Herrera, present. What's up, Phil? TM Crosspulse in the house. Ewa, Ewa, another dear sister. Welcome, guys. Oh, the good people are here. Amazing, guys. Also, our regulars, John Villegas, Muhammad Allah, Rabbi Eduardo, Just Janice, Bill Shepherd, let's see, Jennifer, welcome. Safir al-Masih says, Muhammad is a fraud. Exactly, like Zakir Naik would have said. Nemesis, welcome, nice to see you. Shandish Bernur. Charles D, Nim Grace, August D, Warren. Hello, Warren. How are you? Welcome. Thank you for being here, guys. Try to invite as many people as you can. Don't forget to subscribe. Smash that like button and click on the notification bell to receive a notification. You know how YouTube works by now, right, guys? Please invite, share the link to today's live show on social media. Allow it to go viral. We have a lot of meat today again. Today, guys, let me switch the screens. Today, we have two main topics. Who is exactly Allah according to Muhammad? And Muhammad said, this is Allah. This is how Allah looks like. I mean, look at my Photoshop skills, man. Anyway, we're going to talk about that. And we also have another topic that I wanted to talk about. Today, I had to edit. Because I noticed that Mimi Hijab had a conversation. It was not a debate. It was a conversation with Jordan B. Peterson. And Muhammad Hijab something said something during that interview. And I really need to address that regarding Isaiah 42. Because Muhammad Hijab said, the Prophet is mentioned in several places in the Bible, especially in Isaiah 42. So we're going to take a deep dive and see if he's a liar or not. All right, those are basically the main topics of today. I hope everybody is ready. As you know, guys, as you know, we always start with a nice prayer. Because we always need to ask our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ to bless the live stream, to bless everybody here. God is everything. Without God, we are nothing. We are nothing but dust. So we need our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ to bless us, to be with us. Remember, whenever Christians mention the name of Christ, he is going to be among us. That's what Jesus said. If two people mention my name or are gathered in my name, I'll be the third. That's what Jesus said. So pray with me. In the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. بِإِسْمَ الْأَبْ وَالْإِبْنِ وَالْرُوحَ الْقُدُسِ إِلَهًا وَاحِدٍ بِشَيْمْ أَبُو وَبْرُو رُوحُ قَدِيشُ حَالُهُ شَرِيرُ أَمِينٍ. In the Aramaic, we pray. نَحْنُ نُصَلِّي. Father, thank you for allowing me to do another live stream again. Please, Lord, bless our audience, all the admins and our subscribers and patrons who are supporting us. Please bless them. Bless all of us. Please bless all the admins and subscribers, including our loved ones and families. In your holy name, O Christ, we pray. Please keep all of us healthy and safe, especially the ones who are risking their lives in exposing this false cult of Muhammad, this man-made cult of Muhammad that has been nothing but a cancer, deceiving so many Muslims through the centuries. Please, Lord, open the eyes of the Muslims. We do not hate them. We actually love them. Open their eyes so they can be saved as we are saved. Lord, I beg you, I want to ask you to keep my wife and baby boy healthy and safe. Protect them and bless them, Father. And bless everybody who is here now and listening and watching to our very live stream. Please, Lord, I ask you to protect all the Christians on this planet who are persecuted in your holy name above all names, O Christ. Our Christian brothers and sisters in countries like Pakistan, Afghanistan, Indonesia, Egypt, Lebanon, Syria, Iraq, and in the rest of the countries which I did not mention, O Lord. Please, Lord, God over them. Lord Christ, I pray to you and ask you to cleanse us with your holy blood and fill us with your Holy Spirit. Please shine your holy light on all of us, including the Muslims, the Muslimin, who might be in need and are seeking for the truth, O Lord. We care about those ones, O Lord. Please open their eyes. We have hope for everybody, O Lord. Please, Lord, guide them back home, please. Christ, fill me with your Holy Spirit and loosen my tongue today on this very live stream and guide me so I can speak the truth, al-haq, nothing but the truth, without any error or any shame. And Lord, give us wisdom and courage to do whatever needs to be done. In your holy name, O Jesus Christ, we pray. Amen. Amen. We are live, baby. We are live. Speaking from cave. Hira, Hira. We are live. 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 Welcome, everybody. I hope everybody is ready. I know I'm ready. I hope that means that you are ready to invite, share, guys, and let us actually start today's live show. All right, all right. Let us start with the first topic, guys. We have mentioned this before on our live shows, but I really didn't go deep on this topic because Muhammad said that Allah looks like a young man. Allah looks like a young man with curly hair, and many Muslims don't know about it. So we need to bring this up more often, because they always say, there's nothing like Allah. لا مثله شيء. There's nothing like Allah. But when we take a deep dive in the Islamic most authentic sources, we get a shocking response back from the Prophet of Islam himself, from authentic narrations, that Allah would have looked like this, like a young man with curly hair wearing green suit. Let's say a green t-shirt. This is Allah, brother, and this is the Prophet. You see it? And Muhammad was always using Allah, his hand puppet, for his sexual desires. And remember what Aisha used to say? مَا أَرَى رَبُّكَ إِلَّا يُسَارَ فِي هَوَاكَ يَا مُحَمَّدْ. Aisha used to say, aha, Aisha said, I see that your Lord hastens to fulfill your desires, ya Muhammad. Funny stuff. Rob, can you prove that Muhammad truly have said that this is Allah? This is how Allah would have looked like. A very handsome young man, right? Beautiful skin, curly hair, wearing a green suit. Yes, I can. Just wait. Just wait. Before we go there, guys, let us do a small introduction and see what the Quran says about certain things regarding this topic. Now, Muslims always attack us, and they attack our Bible. They attack us Christians and us Jews, the Jews and the Christians, because they say, you Christians and Jews, and this is what the Quran says also, and it's attacking us, our one of main doctrines in Christianity and the Holy Bible. And as you see, the Quran is written by much later man who wanted to create their own cult. And I believe, as we mentioned in our last live show, that Islam, the Quran itself started like a lectionary, Aramaic lectionary book, right? Right? To confirm the previous scripture. But later Muslims, let's say in the Umayyad and Abbasid Caliphate, they started to change the Quran and make it as if it's refuting Christianity and the Bible. That's what I believe after studying and seeing what actually the Quran says and the Muslim sources. Chapter 5, Surah Al-Ma'idah, the table, the Ma'idah, Al-Ma'idah, Ayah 18. It says here the following, and I want you to read with me, guys. Please focus. Admins, take care of the live chat. My live chat is in your hands. Guys, our admins will provide also the reference in the live chat, but also in the comment section. Phil Herrera often does that, and our other admins will provide also the timestamps if you missed today's live show for some reason, maybe because of work or whatnot. So you're all, we got you, friends. We got you, okay? So don't worry. We'll try to make things very smooth for you. So, chapter 5, ayah 18. The Jews and the Christians said, we are the sons of Allah and His beloved ones. Right? And here, basically, Muhammad, in his yellow pages, in his Quran, is saying, you Christians and Jews, you say, your God in the Holy Bible, is your father. That's what basically the Quran is trying to say. Say, so Allah says to Muhammad, we know there's nothing called Allah, it's always Muhammad fabricating these ayahs and the writers of the Quran. Say, why does your God then punish you for your sins? In fact, you are human beings. So the Quran wants to tell us, how can you say that your God is your father, your heavenly father? You're nothing but human beings. So this actually shows us the ignorance and the illiteracy of the one who wrote the Quran. If Muslims want to say this is Allah speaking, well, you have a problem, because your Allah does not know that when Jews and Christians say, or when we read in our Bible, for example, in Deuteronomy 32, verse 6, that God actually begot Israel. Israel is the first son or the firstborn son of God. When God is saying that, it doesn't mean that God had sex with several women, or God forbid, that's pure blasphemy. But the Quran here is assuming that when we say God is our father, they think it's all about through sexual relationship. God forbid, like Zeus, the Greek gods, for example, who had sex with earthly women to get sons and whatnot, sons and daughters. So the writer of the Quran is really an illiterate, right? Yeah, and Israel is Jacob, exactly. So we can find this in Deuteronomy 32:6, but also, for example, in Deuteronomy 14, verse 1, where it says that the Bani Israel are Muslimin. The Bani Israel are the sons of God. So this proves that your Quran is a man-made, messed up book that has no idea what the Jews and the Christians believe, let alone what the Bible actually says. It's pure blasphemy what your Quran is trying to say here. You're nothing but human beings. You idiot. The writer of the Quran, if Muslims claim this is Allah, that means Allah is an idiot. Allah is an illiterate, a jahil like his prophet. Because nowhere does the Bible teach, God forbid, it's pure blasphemy what the Quran is saying here, that God had sexual relationships with women, let alone getting them pregnant through sexual intercourse. This Quran is such a disgusting, evil book created by a man who only was thinking not through his brains, clearly he has no brains, but through his penis. It's nothing but a carnal book written by a sexual perverted man, as you see in front of you. And this is not only the only ayah in the Quran that is talking about that, also in chapter 19. Look, Surah Maryam, chapter 19, ayahs 88 to 92, I believe. Look, and the disbelievers said, the Most Gracious has chosen an offspring. You see it? So here, again, the Quran is attacking the Jews and the Christians again, especially the Christians. The Most Gracious, Ar-Rahman, right? Ar-Rahman has chosen an offspring. That's a lie from hell. You see it? Again, pure blasphemy, that's not what we say. When we say God is our father, that means he's our spiritual father. But again, the Quran is written by an illiterate who has no idea what the Bible says. Pure blasphemy, man. And look, if we continue reading, ayah 89, you have indeed brought an extremely grave speech. No, you are nothing but an illiterate jahil, O Allah, if Muslims are going to claim this is Allah. And he continues saying, you know, you are basically blaspheming, and the earth is going to be split because of your lies, and the mountains are shaking and falling down. And again, repeating again, do their ascribing of an offspring to the Most High, to the Most Gracious. And it does not befit the Most Gracious to choose. And I mean, the writer of the Quran needs to repeat himself, because the first time in ayah 88, it was not clear enough, right? Ya Muslimin? Your Allah, if you're going to claim this is Allah's speech, Allah needs to repeat himself, because it seems that the Quran is not clear enough. Allah sounds like a copy machine. Control C, right? Control V. Allah is doing Control C, Control V. Copy, paste. It's not enough. Allah needs to repeat it 3 times. Imagine, guys, 3 times. Offspring. Offspring. Offspring, brother. 3 times at least. I mean, you have problems, brother? Maybe the writer of the Quran has OCD of sorts. I don't know, man. There's something fishy going on. Anyway, and it becomes even more worse for Allah, I mean Muhammad. If we go to Surah Al-Anbiya, chapter 21, ayah 17. Welcome, Bjorn Sparket. God bless you. Nice to see you. We have also someone from Denmark. Well, that's amazing. Welcome. Everybody who just joined, you didn't miss much. Thank you for being here. God bless you. Hello, Adrian Dico, one of the admins who just joined. All the admins, guys, who just joined. TM Crosspulse, nice to see you. Everybody, Warren, welcome. Please invite, guys. Please invite. Keep inviting and allow the numbers to grow, because we are bringing down the hammer on the fraud prophet of Islam and his man-made Qur'an. This Qur'an needs to attack the Bible. It needs to attack one of the main doctrines of the Bible, but failing miserably, showing that the writer of this Qur'an, this book, is a pure illiterate person who had no idea what the Jews and the Christians believed when they said, God is our heavenly spiritual father. The writer of the Quran continuously needs to prove that he's an illiterate. He has no idea that there's nothing called physical sexual interference between God, the Father, and women. Look, guys, again, Muhammad, there's nothing called Allah again. This is the illiteracy of Muhammad and the writers of the Quran in Ayah 17 here. Said, had we desired to take to us lahwan, the word is lahwan, to us, us. How many gods are there in Islam, guys? Muslims. When Allah says we, and when Allah says us, how many gods do you have in Islam? You always say that there's only one God in Islam, that's Allah. But when Allah says us, lahwan, who is he talking about? Who is Allah talking about? Maybe Jibreel is God too? Maybe the Hur al-Ain? We'll see. We'll see. If we go to the tafsir. So us, a diversion, we would have taken it to us from ourselves. Again, us from ourselves. Who are the from ourselves? Seems that there are more than one divine being in the Quran and Islam. Who is the ourselves? Who is Allah associating himself with? How many partners does Allah have in Islam? Guys, do you see the disaster in this very ayah? Chapter 21, ayah 17. Take notes. Who is the ourselves? Muslims? Christians? I want to learn. I mean, maybe I have no idea what... maybe I don't understand the ayah. Maybe someone can explain it to me. Who is the ourselves? Now, I'm not a scholar. I will never dare to claim that I'm a scholar. I'm only asking the right questions. I am reading, and then I, after reading and finding these disasters in this man-made messed up book, which they call the Quran, I have to ask some serious questions after reading these ayahs. Now, to understand it, let us go to a Muslim scholar. Who is better than Al-Jalalain? Al-Jalalain... Al-Jalalain himself, Al-Suyuti, who wrote Tafsir Al-Jalalain. The same chapter, same ayah. Surah Al-Anbiya, chapter 21, ayah 70, Tafsir Al-Jalalain. Do you see it? Let me give you the link, guys. Let me give you the link and let us read together. Had we desired... So basically, as Allah is saying, the writer of the Quran is saying, had we desired to find some diversion, meaning a partner, right? Maybe a sex partner, I don't know, that which provides diversion in the way of a sexual partner. So you see, Muhammad always thinking with his penis. It's all about sex, offsprings, sexual interference, sexual relationship of Allah with another partner. We would have found it with ourselves. Now, when Allah says ourselves, he is actually comparing himself to other beings. But Muslims love to tell us there is nothing like Allah. There is nothing like Allah. La mithlihi shay. Well, Allah makes it clear that there are multiple beings that are divine like him, basically. The ourselves. Now, who are they? From among the beautiful eyed huris with the big melons and the beautiful front passages, brother. So it seems that the huris are divine beings. One, huri or hur al-ayn, guys. The beautiful eyed huris are divine beings, right? And Jibreel, angels. Angels like Jibreel are divine too. Uh-oh. So if Allah wants to have a child, brother, Allah might sleep with Jibreel or a beautiful eyed huri. Because Allah is saying these are the ourselves. From among the beautiful eyed huris and angels. Those are the ourselves, guys. Ding, 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 ding. Wow! Do you see how Muhammad again is proving when he's attacking the Bible and he's attacking the Jews and the Christians regarding when we say God is our heavenly father, God is our father, the writer of the Quran is clearly thinking with his penis, because everything is through sex. Everything in this cult is about sex. Sex, sex, sex. Everything is 18 plus. Whenever Muhammad talks in the Quran, it's always 18 plus, guys. So this is why we always say, keep your children away from our live streams. You see it? But then Allah says, but we did not do so, thus we never desired. So, but if Allah wanted to have a child, He would have taken it from ourselves, right? By sleeping with Jibreel. Maybe Allah and Jibreel is having sexy time, brother. Or with a beautiful, big-breasted huri, brother. Right? With a large melon, brother. Uh-huh. This makes sense why the Quran and the writer of the Quran is really illiterate about the Holy Bible, because the writer of the Quran was thinking with his penis when he was writing these ayahs down, right? This is crystal clear proof. And I challenge any Muhammadan to call us live on air. Is there any Muslim guys in the live chat? If not, you Christians have some homework to do. You need to invite Muslims, right? Abdurrahman, guys, we have some wonderful news. Abdurrahman just sent me a message and I think he's watching my live show. Remember our brother Abdurrahman? He left Islam the other day on our live show. I had at least a 3-hour conversation in total with him. And he just said, hey Rob, I searched deeply in the past few days and I accepted Christ. Hallelujah! Hallelujah, guys! Another day of days, Abdurrahman became a Christian. He says, he sent me two hearts, do you see it? Beating hearts. And he says, a great miracle occurred to me. However, I do not want to really talk about it. That's okay, Abdurrahman. If you're listening, it's okay. I understand. It's really not easy for a Muslim to leave Islam and become a Christian. I understand how difficult that must be for you. But my friend, like we always say, don't fear anyone. Don't fear anyone. You might. I mean, I can now go outside and maybe a truck hits me from behind and I die. But at least I know that I'm saved. I know that I am going back to my Lord and Savior Jesus Christ, who promised me true salvation. So don't worry, my friend. Make sure, Abdurrahman, let me type it out also for him. Make sure to get baptized in a Trinitarian church. In a Trinitarian church, in the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. That's very important, that you are baptized in the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit to finalize your journey, my friend. God bless you, Abdurrahman. We are really happy for you. People in the live chat, please give our dear brother in Christ, Abdurrahman, roses and congratulate him, guys. Keep him in your prayers. Lord willing, also his family members might find Jesus in their lives. Pray for them, guys. Pray for everybody. Oh, man, I see that I need to address many, many messages. Brother Al-Fadi from Syria International is probably inviting me to do a live show soon. Okay. I hope I won't forget that. Well, congratulations, Abdurrahman. I'm really happy for you, my friend. I will keep you in my prayers. Stay safe. And you will see how your life is going to totally change. God bless you, my friend. God bless. We are happy for you, Abdurrahman. Congratulations, Habibi. Rabb, yubarak hayatak. Rabb, wal-mukhallis, Yesu al-Masih. The real Jesus Christ, Yesu al-Masih, not Isa, the fake version. That's the fake Antichrist version, Isa. The real Jesus, Yesu al-Masih, Yeshua, Yeshua Mashiach in Aramaic. God bless you, Abdurrahman. Wonderful news, man. What a day to start your live stream with. Guys, is this amazing or what? Hallelujah. I'm speechless, man. I'm speechless. I don't know what to say, man. Guys, and they say, Muslims say, Rob, nobody takes you seriously. We Muslims don't watch your live show. But it turns out every week a Muslim leaves and becomes a Christian because of our live shows. Every week we have Muslims watching our live shows and leaving Islam, and some of them even become Christians. The proof is in front of you. Guys, please, when we say spread our videos, share the link to of our live shows on social media, allow them to go viral, invite. We know why we are saying this. Because we want these people to get saved. Yes, we cannot save anyone. But we can guide them to the truth. And the only person, the only God who can save Muslims is nobody else than Jesus Christ. Glory to his name. His name above all names. Please, Christians, we have some homework to do. We have a lot of work to do together. We are one body. We need to work as a team. I need your help. Spread my videos. For the love of God, spread my videos. If you care about human beings, if you want them to be saved, please, I beg you, spread our videos. God bless you, Abdurrahman, and God bless any Muslim who might not even send me a message that he left Islam. I don't care. I don't want your messages. I just want you to be saved. I don't hate any Muslim. Muslims, ya Muslimin. We do not hate you. We love you. This is why we are doing this. We want you to be saved. That's it. That's all. Okay. Man. That was amazing. Amazing news. Wonderful news. So early. Wow. I'm speechless, man. Abdurrahman, I'm really happy for you, my friend. You were a brother in humanity. Now you have become a brother in Christ. Hallelujah. Hallelujah, guys. Hallelujah. 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 Abdurrahman, according to the Bible, according to the Injil, there is a huge celebration right now in the kingdom of God. Because if one soul gets saved and comes back home, the angels are celebrating because just one soul is saved. Do you see how important just one soul is for God? Just one soul. What about many souls? Man, huge celebration today. All right, let's continue. Chapter 6, Surah Al-An'am. Chapter 6, Surah Al-An'am. Makes it even more clear. Chapter 6, Surah Al-An'am, Ayah 101. 101 says, He, Allah, is the originator of the heavens and the earth. How can he have children when he has no? And the word is sahiba. Sahiba means a girlfriend. The Muslims are too desperate and they need to sugarcoat and lie in the translations It does not say wife. It says sahiba. Sahi. Any Arabic speaking person knows that the word sahiba means a girlfriend. So Allah must have a girlfriend to have children, to have offsprings. Again, the writer of the Quran, if Muslims say this is Allah, well, I will go with you. Your Allah clearly must think with his penis. Allah must use his penis to get children. Again, if the Quran here is attacking the Holy Bible, attacking the triune God, it shows again to everybody who is watching that Allah and his alleged prophet have no clue what the Bible says. That's pure blasphemy. Pure blasphemy here in this ayah. Our God does not need a girlfriend, sahiba, girlfriend, to have children. Because we, Jews and Christians, we believe that God is a spiritual father, not through sex or sexual relationships with his girlfriends. This is pure blasphemy. Again, this shows and exposes the man-made Quran and the most obvious fake prophet in history, Muhammad, who is an illiterate, son of an illiterate, a jahil, son of a jahil. This is man. The only miracle, guys, the only miracle in this cult that there are over a billion idiots, clowns, who believe that the Quran is a divine book from a divine being. Pure blasphemy. You see, when the writer of the Quran, when he wrote the Quran, he was nothing but an agnostic, a heretical Christian, right? Who had no idea what he was talking about. Proving that the Quran is a man-made book. Because clearly Allah in chapter 6, ayah 101, and chapter 21, ayah 17, for example, that we mentioned, he is actually is proving that if you're going to say this is Allah, that means Allah, the writer of the Quran, has no single clue about the Holy Bible, let alone about the triune God, the Trinity. The writer of the Quran is clearly a human like you and me who is making embarrassing mistakes. And you dare to say, ya Muslimin, who are watching, you dare to say this is a God? Can your God, your Allah, make such mistakes and get away with it? How can you claim this is God? Can God make such embarrassing mistakes when he's attacking the God of the Bible and the Jews and the Christians? Do you see, guys, why the www, the internet, YouTube, our live streams, why it's such a nuclear tool, a nuclear bomb that we can use and drop on the face of Islam and the Ummah to allow many Muslims to leave Islam, become apostates, and come back home to Jesus Christ? Like Abdurrahman. Abdurrahman is a good example, right? Abdurrahman, who left Islam in just 2 weeks. He started to question Islam. He started to question his faith. And he had no other option left than to leave Islam and come back home and become a Christian. If you care about your salvation, I don't want you to care about me, Muslims. If you care about your soul, because your soul is precious, please leave this cult. This cult that has been deceiving you the moment you are born in this evil cult of yours, because of your families and whatnot. They told you the moment you are born, don't question Islam. Ittaqillah, fear Allah. Don't ask questions. Right? Yunus Abuti. Call me and let's see who's the real idiot. My Skype is open. Look, Yunus, I opened my Skype for people like you. For me, you're very special, brother, Yunus. Yeah, Yunus. Instead of calling me an idiot, let's see who's the real idiot. You, me, or your Allah and Prophet? What do you think? Call me. My Skype ID is the Rob Christian. Admins, give my Skype ID in the live chat, please. If you are lucky, maybe Yunus, if he claims to be a man, more man than his mother Aisha, ya Ibn Aisha, ya Ibn Aisha, ittasil fi. Call me. I'm live I'm talking to you. If you are not a boy, you are not running from me. Call me or ask your father or maybe your mother, who's the real man of the house, or maybe your sheikh, to call me instead. But make sure to say inshallah 3 times. Kavrik Linda Clark says, Rob Christian, tell Muslims what the Bible says about the incarnation of Jesus. Well, if we go, for example, to John 1, we see that in the beginning, let me put it on the screen. John 1, if we put it on the screen, look at Muslims and see how your Allah is a illiterate. Your Quran is written by illiterate because your Quran has no idea. When we say Jesus is the Son of God, your Quran, your prophet had no clue, proving that the Quran is a man-made book and your prophet is a fraud, a fake prophet. Look, this is John 1. In the beginning was the Word, and the Word was with God. And the Word, Al-Kalima, was God. بالبدء كان الكلمة والكلمة كان عند الله not كانت but كان it's a person كان and the word is a person and was with God and that same word that person that word was God so we have the Father and we have the Son do you see it the Father and the Son is that word who existed with God from the very beginning and if you go to Genesis you see that God the Spirit is hovering the waters. So we have in the Bible already the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit, the Trinity. We don't say Trinity. We don't say that our God is a triune God, right? Three persons in one. We don't say that for nothing because that's what the Bible, if you read it carefully, unlike your Jahil prophet, your fraud fake prophet who had never read the Bible because this is why he's making such mistakes. In chapter 21, ayah 17, chapter 6, ayah 101, and so on. You see, the same was in the beginning with God. So, God is the Word is God. Al-Kalima, who Allah, that's what you would say in the Arabic. Al-Kalima, who Allah, Allah, who Al-Kalima. Right? And all things are created or were made by the Word of God. So, when God speaks, Jesus creates. Again, since Jesus is the Word of God, so when God speaks, that Word is creating. So Jesus is the Creator, do you see it? The Father, the Son creates. And everything was made by Jesus Christ. In Him was life. So when Jesus said, I am the way, the truth, and life, now you understand why? Because He is the Creator of life. He's the Founder of life. There you see it. And when we finally scroll down, all the way down to verse 14, it becomes even more clear for any Muslim. Verse 14, John 1, 14, it says, and the Kalima, Al-Kalima, Jesus Christ himself, the Word, was made flesh. So you see, God took on a flesh body and dwelt among us. And we beheld his glory. Subhan Yesu al-Masih. Subhan Jesus Christ. His glory. That glory as of the only begotten of the Father, full of grace and truth. Do you see it? Muslims, please wake up. Yes, hello, you're live on air.
Muslims, please wake up.
Mute YouTube.
Then I'll meet you.
Donkey Ibn Donkey. With his many nicknames. I have no time for kids. Ultimate fart again, guys. The fart guy. The farty fart. Same guy. I knew it, guys. Because he always stops a couple of seconds. You know? That's his introduction. He needs to show us what kind of amazing guy this guy is. This Rashad Khalifa boy. Who even uses a corrupted version of the Quran. Chapter 9 of his Quran misses the last two ayahs. Chapter 9, for example. Anyway. So again, do you see? The writer of the Quran, let us go back, guys. Don't allow anyone like these idiots, these trolls, to distract you. We have admins for that. The writer of the Quran is clearly a human who is making embarrassing mistakes. Jews and Christians do not believe that God made a woman. Jews and Christians do not believe that God, the Father, made a woman like Mary pregnant. That's pure blasphemy. God forbid. Pure blasphemy. So the Quran is nothing but a satanic book. Christians here in the West, wake up. Never ever respect the Quran, because the Quran is attacking your God. The Quran is a satanic book that is attacking your God with lies and deception, proving that the writer of the Quran is a human, a Satanist, Muhammad himself, the prophet of Satan. We don't respect the book of Satan, which is the Quran. Do you see how clear this is? Yet the Quran is saying, if Allah wished to have a child, a son, Allah first must find himself a girlfriend, sahiba, and start a sexual relationship. I mean, this God, man, this false God, must first have a sahiba, a girlfriend, and sleep with that sahiba. Then, if he wanted to have a child, first needs sexual relationship with a girl to get a child. You see how the writer of the Quran always think with his penis? Nilufa A, call me Nilufa A. I want to have a nice, respectful discussion with you. Nilufa A, seems that you are a Muslim. I want you to call me, live on air, right here, right now. I'm talking to you. Call me on Skype. My Skype ID is the Rob Christian. So download Skype, put your email in it, log in, and look for my name, the Rob Christian, without separation. I want to talk with you. Is that okay? Since you think you know Islam, I want to learn from you. I want to have a conversation. Maybe you can invite me. Maybe you can do da'wah to me. Maybe you can invite me back to Islam, brother. I will learn Islam. This is why we're doing it. We want to learn about Islam, man. Nilufa A, you're calling me a liar. Talk is cheap. I can call anyone a liar, but prove it. Show us where I'm lying. Show us where I'm lying. Talk is cheap. Come and refute me and show everybody that I'm lying. You are calling me a liar. I want you to refute me, actually. I would love it for a Muslim to refute me, to show everybody that I'm a liar. I want you to show everybody that I'm a liar. Any Muslim who thinks he has the courage or the knowledge to refute me, my name is Rob Christian, I'm one of the enemies of Allah and his Rasul, call me and show everybody, show all the corners of this world that I'm a liar, because our live streams are reaching all countries, man. Do you have any idea, Muslims, what kind of damaging tool my YouTube channel is to the Ummah? Do you have any idea how many Muslims are leaving Islam because of my videos and live shows? It's for you. It's your homework. It's your job to call me and refute me. Because if you can refute me, I might close my YouTube channel, man. Because of me, many Muslims are leaving Islam. Talk is cheap. Rob Christian, you're lying. Okay, prove it. I want you to prove it. Maybe you can bring me a scholar, or maybe one of your heroes like Sister Farida, or people from EF Dawah. Let them call. Maybe Mimi Hijab, the golden showers boy who took off his shirt and showed his titties right in front of the Chinese embassy. Maybe Mimi Hijab can show us his beautiful body, his shaved beautiful body. You know, maybe he flexes his muscles on Skype. I can make him famous again. I mean, these people, everything is a show for them. Show us your face, Rob. Everything is a show in Islam. Me strong. Right? Me my hijab. Any Muslim guys? I mean, look, today again, another Muslim left Islam and became a Christian, life on air. Abdurrahman is left Islam and became a Christian. Niloufa A, since you are a Muslim, it's your duty, it's your job to stop me, because many Muslims are leaving Islam because of my shows. Niloufa A, I'm a disgraceful person. You want to go there? Your prophet, said to his own Sahaba, go bite on the penis of your fathers. So who is the disgraceful one? Have I ever said to my brothers and sisters here, such kind of language, filthy language? Your prophet said that in a very sahih hadith. Right? Your prophet used people like you, if you're a woman, Niloufa, I think you're a woman. Your prophet used women like you as whores, used them for mut'ah. Your sisters, your daughters, he slept with them for a couple of hours, like the Sahaba. So if you want to talk about disgrace, your prophet is pure disgrace, your Sahaba are disgrace. And your Allah, who is allowing mut'ah in chapter 4, ayah 24, he is the disgrace. You want to go there? You want to go there? Your prophet and your Allah called us najis, and he called us animals. You want to go there? Everything you say will be used against your prophet and fake idol, stone idol Allah in the court of law today. My live show is the court of law. Whenever you say something, it will go back to your prophet. Dumb liar. Okay, you're very smart. You're very smart. You're very smart. That's the only thing she has, guys. You're a dumb liar. I really pity your brainwashed half brains. Again, I really pity your brainwashed half brains. Your prophet used to command women to take out their breasts like Aisha and suckle grown-up people. What? Really? Yes. Look. Look, brother. Look, brother. Aisha used to take out her breasts. Right? This is Aisha, brother. Since you want to go there, let us go there. No problem. This is Aisha. Aisha used to say to grown-up men, open wide and say, prove it, Rob. Sure. If we go to the book of Ibn Ashur, tafsir for the Quran, for Surah An-Nisa, tafsir, At-Tahrir wal-Tanwir, Tafsir At-Tahrir wal-Tanwir by Ibn Ashur, a very giant Maliki scholar, Maliki Sunni scholar, volume 4. And we go to his book. We open the page. Page 297, it's in front of you, people. How dare you to call me a liar? Watch. Tafsir, Surah An-Nisa. Now let us see who is disgraceful. Let us see who has no honor and no dignity. Me or your prophet? Watch. Your prophet used to command Aisha to take out her breast. Here, Surah An-Nisa. وَكَانَتْ عَائِشَ أُمْ الْمُؤْمِنِينَ إِذَا أَرَادَتْ أَنْ يَدْخُلْ عَلَيْهَا أَحَدْ الْحِجَابِ أَرْضَعَتْهُ. What? أَرْضَعَتْهُ. Again, the translation. If any man wanted to enter upon Aisha, if Aisha, the mother of the believers, wanted a man to enter upon her, she what? She breastfed him. Here, let me make it even more big. Maybe you have a problem with your eyes, Muslims. She breastfed him. And who was commanding her to do that? Look, ذَلِكْ مِنْ إِذْنِ النَّبِي صَلَّى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمُ. So it was on the permission, on the command of Muhammad, for Aisha to take out her breasts and suckle men. So you want to go there? Who is a disgraceful person? You? Me or your prophet? Where is the honor? Where is the honor of the prophet? Truly, Muhammad had no honor because he was asking his wives to take out their breasts and suckle young men with huge beards. So you want to go there? Do you want me to continue embarrass your fake nasty, sexually perverted prophet who had no honor and he had no shame? Imagine, guys. Imagine. Put this in front of you. Muhammad, who claims to be the final prophet, the seal of all the prophets, the best creation and the best example that Muslims need to follow, this sexually perverted, nasty, evil son of Satan, who they call Muhammad, is commanding his baby bride Aisha to take out her breast and breastfeed young men with beards. 8, 9, 10 Well, you need to tell Allah that and Muhammad. I'm not a Muslim. ABC. Why are you like looking at me? I'm not the prophet. Muhammad is commanding his wife Aisha to breastfeed young men. Don't look at me. It says he arda'athu. You're an idiot, man. And don't spam ABC. Don't spam. I already saw your comment. Don't tell me that. Go tell your prophet that. Your prophet had no idea. But clearly Muhammad wanted, again, clearly Muhammad wanted Aisha, even if she had no milk, to breastfeed young men because he enjoyed being a cuckold. Muhammad was a what? Cuckold. Sorry if I'm butchering the word, but you get the idea. Muhammad enjoyed watching other strangers, other men, to suckle on the nipples of his wives. Who cares if there's milk or no milk? Your prophet was an evil son of Satan, a sexual pervert. He enjoyed watching his wives suckle other men. It's a fetish of Muhammad, bruh. Wake up, hello. ABC, hello. Your prophet enjoyed giving his wives to other strangers to... Can you show the reference again? Here is the reference. Tafsir al-Tahrir wa al-Tanwir. Take a screenshot, take a selfie. Tafsir al-Tahrir wa al-Tanwir for Surah An-Nisa, chapter 4, by Ibn Ashur, volume 4. Tafsir for the Quran, for Surah An-Nisa. Aisha, yes, Prophet Brada, go suckle young men with beards. Okay, brother, prophet, brother, I will do that. Abdul Fattah says, "I'm a Muslim." Look at this filth, guys. Look at these nasty people who have no honor and who have no shame. Abdul Fattah says, "Look what Abdul Fattah says, guys. Please read with me and try not to get disgusted." Abdul Fattah says, "I am Muslim and I don't disagree with this nor embarrass about it. So it's okay for you when a man comes to your house, Ya Abdul Fattah, and you command your wife to take out her tits and suckle him." Really? So let's say your cousin comes to see you and wants to play video games at your house. So first you need to say to, let's say, Hassan is your cousin. "Hassan, wait, let me first get my wife so she can take her boobs out, suckle you 10 times. Oh wait, it was abrogated to 5 times. So come back 5 times again. Today, your stomach is filled with the milk. Come back tomorrow and the day after that. And when, you know, the 5 suckling finished, you finished drinking from my cow, I mean my wife, then you are finally allowed to enter our house. Suckle him." So again, Abdul Fattah, you just showed us that you have no honor, you have no shame, like a prophet. Congratulations. Congratulations, Abdul Fattah. Congratulations. And ABC says, "Rob Christian doesn't know Arabic." That's the only thing they have. Rob Christian doesn't know. Okay, I don't know Arabic. You Muslims know Arabic. ABC, okay, you know what? Call me live on air and read the Arabic for me. Challenge, ABC. Call me. My Skype ID is the Rob Christian. I'm going to force you to read the Arabic. Show us how your Arabic is. I want to know your Arabic skills. Okay? My mic is broken. His mic is broken, guys. Brother, my telephone mic is broken. Guys, when I receive calls, I can talk, but my mic is broken. You see these silly, embarrassing, desperate excuses and lies of the Muslims today, guys? Do you see how they are allowed to lie to you, guys? When I always say to Christians, to my audience, Christians, please learn. Whenever you talk to Muslims, they are allowed to deceive you and lie in your face. Stop being humble to these lies and deceivers. They don't deserve you to respect them. These kind of people don't deserve respect. Christians, wake up. Wake up here in the West. My mic doesn't work. My mic is broken. Yeah, only your Muslim mics, you know. I mean, what's wrong with your Muslim telephones, man? What kind of telephones you guys use? Guys, yes, that's the correct way to do it. ABC needs, to cool down because his lies are not working. Everybody here ate his seven ajwa and we became immune for black magic poison. And because we are people of the book, we are Christians, we get the third extra option. We get immune for the lies, taqiyya and makr of the Muslims like their Allah. You see how these people have no shame, no honor or any dignity? They would allow their wives, they would command their wives to breastfeed young men. Well, it's your funeral, it's your janazah, these are your wives, not my wives. All right? Be happy. Now guys, again, Allah of the Quran needs to have a sahiba. He must get himself a sahiba, have sex with her, else how can he have children? How can Allah else have children? You see how Allah has a penis, guys? Allah is a human who has a penis. Yes, hello, Mr. Muslim man.
Yes, hello, Mr. Muslim man.
Ultimate Donkeys? I think it's Ultimate Donkey. Yes, speak, Ultimate Donkey, speak.
And you're wrong.
Donkey Ibn Donkey. I knew it, guys. I knew it. I know his tactics. I knew it. Okay, let us continue. Chapter 36. Let me prove now, guys, that Allah is a human being. When Muhammad said, this is Allah, he was correct. Even the Quran confirms that Allah is a human being. Rob, really? No, get out of here, Rob. Are you saying that chapter 36, ayah 1 says that Allah is a human? Yes, watch. If we go to chapter 36, this ayah here in front of you, we get Yasin, and this everything here in the brackets is not there, of course. Only one word. Yasin. Yasin. Okay, what is Yasin? What does Yasin mean in the Quran? Abdul Fattah, call me Abdul Fattah. Tell us what Yasin means. Now I understand why Abdul Rahman had no other option than to leave Islam and become a Christian. Because he's seeing how his fellow ex-Muslim brothers are now tap dancing. They cannot answer questions. I understand. I feel Abdurrahman. I understand you, bro. I feel you. Why you had to leave Islam and become a Christian. I feel you. I feel you, bro. Hey, Adam Seeker in the house. Like, yeah, Adam Seeker, our favorite Murtad. How are you, brother? We have our dear brother, Adam Seeker, who is actually... I found out the other day that he's older than me, but I'm still better looking than him. He's older than me, but I'm better looking than him. Welcome, Adam Seeker. God bless you, brother. Nice to see you. How are you, Adam Seeker? If you want to join us today, feel free, bro. Okay, if you want to join me today on YouTube, feel free, brother. It's a long time that I have spoken to you, my friend. God bless you. Guys, give our brother Adam Seeker some love. Subscribe to his YouTube channel. Like Chris Kloss, another dear brother of mine. Subscribe to their channels, guys. Allow their ministries and YouTube channels to grow. Support your warriors, Christians, please. And spread our videos. Nilufa, the only animal is your prophet, okay? The only animal is your prophet who was commanding his own wives to take out their boobies and suckle young men, okay? Don't go there, Nilufa. No need to insult, okay? Also, I need to continue bringing down the hammer on your prophet and embarrass him even more. So don't try me, okay? You have no idea who you're talking to. Adam Sikir says, man, you're always better looking than me, RC, but I'm the favorite Murtad. Well, that's true. We love you, though. Yeah, we still love you, bro. Don't worry. Peace and blessings to you, brother Adam Seeker, Chris Kloss, all the warriors. Keep them in your prayers, guys. Keep our admins. We have a wonderful, amazing team of admins, guys, who are doing an amazing job in the background. Man, I'm really blessed. It's an honor to be among you, brothers and sisters. And I really hope that we can do more damage to this evil cult of Satan, which is Islam. And we are only using the truth, nothing but the truth. That's our weapon. The truth is our weapon. That's it. Because when you have the truth, you don't need other tools, right, guys? Keep our families in your prayers, guys. And spread our videos. Any Mohammedan guys? Muslims, we have more than 300 people watching. And I know many Muslims are watching and not one dares to call me. Why is that? I mean, if you say inshallah, I'm sure Allah will help you. That's what Allah said. If you're going to say inshallah, I'm going to be with you. So if you are followers of Deen al-Haq, hey Rosemary, nice to see you. Rosemary, we have some wonderful news, Rosemary. You became Christian the other day. You left Islam, you became a Christian. Today I received another message from our brother Abdurrahman. You remember Abdurrahman, right? Abdurrahman just messaged me and he said he left Islam and he became a Christian today. Amazing. So you're not the only one, Rosemary. God bless you again. Nice to see you, Rosemary. Guys, our sister Rosemary left Islam a couple days ago. Keep her in your prayers. Keep her family, her loved ones in your prayers, like Abdurrahman. And Lord willing, many Muslims like them will leave Islam, become apostates, and come back home and become newborn Christians. In the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. God bless you. So many Muslims, guys, and you say Muslims are not watching our videos. Of course not. Rosemary, I'm a nobody. Rosemary, I'm not amazing. Okay, I am nothing. I'm nothing. I'm nothing but your humble servant. I'm a nobody. I'm just here to read and ask the correct question. That's it. I'm only reading and asking the right questions. Right? Don't thank me, please. I'm a nobody. I'm a sinner. I need Jesus myself too. We're all sinners. Only God is amazing. I'm your humble servant. I'm your brother in Christ. I'm your humble servant. I'm here to teach. That's it. We only ask questions. When we read the Quran and the Hadith, we only are asking questions. Rosemary, I'm sure you never heard of this before. Look, Surah Yasin, chapter of the Quran, chapter 36, ayah 1. Look, if we go to the tafsir, we will understand what the word Yasin means. Yasin. Yasin. What does that mean? Let me prove to everybody that Allah is a human. Those two letters mean Allah is a human. Watch. What? No way. Yes. These two letters in Arabic means Allah is a human. Watch. Watch. I hope the website is going to work. Is the website working? No. It's down. Do you see it, guys? It's not working. Let's see if I refresh. Guys, the Saudi government website, this website is owned by the Kingdom of Saudi Arabia. I think they forgot to pay the bill. They are out of oil money. You see, I'm using Ibn Kathir tafsir, but it's not working here. The database has issues, so I have to use the Jordan Kingdom website, owned by the Kingdom of Jordan. Let me go to that website. They forgot to say inshallah. This is why their website is not working, and they forgot to pay the bill. Again, chapter 36, ayah 1. Ibn Kathir. Let's see if we get lucky, we might find it on this website. Let's see. I hope I'm going to get lucky, brother. Look, guys. Again, this is just to show you guys, chapter 36 of the Quran, ayah 1, Tafsir al-Quran al-Azim by Ibn Kathir. Ibn Kathir, again, Tafsir al-Quran al-Azim, Ibn Kathir. Okay, now let us go to the most important part. Look what it says here. An Ibn Abbas. People, who is Ibn Abbas? Who is Ibn Abbas? Christians, who is Ibn Abbas? Who is Ibn Abbas? Christians, if you've paid attention, who is Ibn Abbas in Islam? He is the ink of the Ummah. He is Tarjaman al-Quran, the translator of the Quran. He is the cousin of Muhammad. He is Hibr al-Ummah, the ink of the Ummah, the cousin of Muhammad himself. The tafsir daddy of tafsir daddies for the Quran, right? He's not a joke. If you call him a liar and deceiver, basically you're calling one of the main guys who is explaining the Quran according to Muhammad. Go to him, you're calling him a liar and deceiver. Watch what Ibn Abbas, for example, saying. An Ibn Abbas radiallahu anhuma wa ikrama wa ad-dahak, the smiler. Remember the smiler who said, I was born after 2 years. The smiler with the teeth, he came out of the womb of his mother having teeth after 2 years. So his mother carried him in her belly for 2 years. That's the same guy. Yeah, the same guy. Wa al-Hasan, wa Sufyan, and so on. Inna ya seen bima'na ya insan. Oh boy. According to all these people, we copy that, we put it in Google Translate just to show you what the text is saying, guys. I'm only using Google Translate to show you what the Arabic text is saying. An Ibn Abbas radiallahu anhuma wa ikrama wa dahaq wa al-Hasan wa Sufyan and so on. Inna yaseen bima'na ya insan. These two highlighted words. Ya insan. What does that mean? On the authority of Ibn Abbas, may Allah be pleased with them, and Ikrama, and Ad-Dahak, and Al-Hasan, and Sufyan. That Yaseen, in chapter 36, ayah 1, chapter 36, ayah 1, this ayah, what does that mean? It means, O human, do you see it? O human. It turns out that Yaseen means O human, and it's one of the names of Allah. It's one of the names of Allah. Here is my translation again, guys. Tafsir Ibn Kathir for chapter 36, ayah 1. On the authority of Ibn Abbas, Ikrama, Ad-Dahak, Hassan, and Sufyan bin Uyayna, that Yaseen means O human. Rob, is this one of the names of Allah? Yes. Right? This is... Look, guys. Huwa, look what it says here. Huwa, ism min isma Allah Ta'ala. This Yaseen is one of the names of Allah, the Most High. Wait, copy it again. We put it here. Is one, O human, is, look, O human being is one of the names of Allah. Huwa ism min isma Allah Ta'ala. Uh-oh. So Allah is a human being, Rob? Yes. Chapter 36, ayah 1. Allah, the human. Now I understand why Muhammad said, this is Allah. He looks like a young man with curly hair wearing green clothing. Green suit. Huwa isa min isma Allah ta'ala. Exactly, Fulhurira. If Fulhurira just put the Arabic, huwa isa min isma Allah ta'ala. It's one of the names of Allah. O human means one of the names of Allah. Uh-oh. So Muslims, from now on, don't say there is no God. Say there is no human like Allah. That's your shahada from right now. From now on, say there is no human like Allah. That's your shahada. The first part of the shahada, there is no human like Allah. When you take your shahada again next time, say there is no human like Allah. Okay, Muslims, pinky promise? Muslims, pinky promise? Are you going to keep your promise, Muslims? Pinky promise? I know you're going to keep your promise, right, Muslims? I just showed you from Tafsir Ibn Kathir. Thank you very much, Rob. Let us continue. Again, guys, if you want to get the translation, take a screenshot, because this is my own personal translation for Tafsir Ibn Kathir for chapter 36, ayah 1. Take a selfie, take a screenshot, use it in your debates with Muslims. Young Carty, you're an idiot, man. You're all over the place. Here, let me put you in the corner. Our favorite Murtad, live on air. Welcome, yeah. Bro.
This is your favorite Murtad.
Yo, what's up, brother?
Doing well by the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, and thank you so very much. It's been long, man. It's been long.
Yeah. How are you, bro? I missed you, man.
I am doing very well, but man, this is crazy. You know, I love this Yasin, especially if you read it in Tafsir al-Qurtubi. Man,
it's crazy.
It's crazy.
Yeah. What do you wanna say to everybody, Adam Seeker? We just in couple of days, brother. Just in couple of days, three Muslims left Islam, and two of them, not only left Islam, they became Christians. They had no other options. Rosemary and Abdurrahman, what do you want to say to them? Because guys,
Masha al-Masih.
Ameen. Guys, our brother here, Adam Seeker, subscribed to his YouTube channel. He used to be a Muslim too, right? And he became a Christian. Muslims, look, there is a huge tsunami coming your way, and then it will knock over the Ummah. Wake up.
Praise Lord that you are doing a great job, brother. As always, in just less than a month, three Muslims left Islam and come to Christ. That's awesome,
brother. Those aren't only the people that we know about. What about the Muslims who are watching our shows and videos and who are not telling us that they left Islam? What about those, right? Don't forget about them.
Yeah. Absolutely. And at the same time, in this small channel, I would call this a small channel, brother. 30,000 subscribers, that's a small channel.
Yeah, man.
Imagine what the large channels are doing.
Yeah.
And by the way, if we go to Tafsir al-Qurtubi, it says,
mm-hmm.
So it is like swearing by Allah, this is the name of the Allah.
Yeah,
and
yeah,
then it says that it means Al-Insan. By the way, Insan, yeah. Google Translator did it wrong. Google Translation actually used the word Rajal as man. But yeah, it actually, Al-Insan means human. So Allah can
actually, Google Translate for this time being, he's giving me a correct translation. Look, it says here, perfect. Ya insan, here, this highlighted word, ya insan, it says, oh human being. You see it? So Allah is a human being, and it's one of the names, it's one of the names of Allah Almighty. Do you see it?
Exactly.
It's one of the names, huwa ism min asma Allah ta'ala. Tafsir Ibn Kathir, you find it in Tabari, not only in Ibn Kathir, all of the Mufassirun are saying this. Al-Tabari, yeah, the creme de la creme, Ibn Kathir, and like our brother just mentioned, also in Al-Qurtubi, all of them are saying this.
Brother Rob.
People are saying your sound is low. Can you come closer to the mic, brother?
Is it good, brother, now?
Yeah, now it's better.
Brother, somebody wants to talk to you.
Mm-hmm.
Live.
Who is that somebody, brother?
Do you know Brother Usama Dakdok?
Oh, yeah, yeah, yeah. Oh, yeah, he wants to talk to me.
Right now.
Oh, well, that would be amazing, man.
All right, praise Lord then. There you go.
And hello, brother. How are you?
Hey, brother. Nice to hear from you. Our brother you so Usama Dakdok, guys. This is a day of days. Welcome, brother. Nice to hear from you.
Thank you so much. Appreciate you.
A true living legend among us, guys.
God is good. God is good. Praise the Lord.
Habibi, kifak?
It's good to be with you. And I'm alhamdulillah. It's good to be with you and all your people. And I appreciate you for the ministry and what you're doing.
Thank you,
I want to say something quickly here is, we know from the scripture that God made man, a male and female. He created him.
Yeah.
And he created him on his image.
Oh.
We know from the scripture. We know from the scripture that God said, I don't know how to put this in right words.
Bro, here it's on the screen. It says in Sahih al-Bukhari, it says Allah created Adam in his image.
I know, but Muslims, see, what is written in their book is one thing and what they believe is another thing. Yeah. They do not know what they believe. They literally do not know what they believe. And if you face them with the reality, here is what you believe. Here is what your scholars said. He said, they come up with any excuse. That's not actually what he meant. We know from the scriptures that our Lord and our Savior Jesus Christ, when he came in the flesh, in the person of Jesus Christ, from
amen,
the virgin,
amen.
He was a man. He was two hands, two legs, two eyes, two ears, physically in a shape of a man. Now, we know also from the scriptures that our Lord and our Savior Jesus Christ appeared so many times in the Old Testament, and he appeared like a man.
Amen.
When he talked with Abraham in Genesis 18, he was a man.
Yep.
And he created man on his image. That's why you and I, and man and woman, are one. First of all, they're not two human Allah, God created, but God created one.
Mm-hmm.
And he created that one on his image. And that one was male and female. It's a little bit complicated. And when a man leave his father and unite with his wife, they become one flesh. What
Amen.
One flesh? One human.
Amen.
One insan. One insan. This is the unity between God and man. But there is one thing you talk about, and I heard you just a minute ago. I don't know. Of course, maybe that's not the topic. But talking about the Shahada.
Yeah.
You advise our dear Muslim friends, when they say the Shahada, they must say, Ashhadu annahu.
But because that's what the tafsir of chapter 36, ayah 1 saying, Yasin means Ya Insan. And this is according to Ibn Abbas and Ikrama and the Haq and
bunch
so on.
And what I love it here when you read al-Tabari, he started his interpretation for Yasin, Ikhtalafa.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Whenever you read in the interpretation of the verse of the Quran, Muslim scholar disagree.
Sorry for interrupting. Guys, when our brother here is saying Muslim scholars always disagree. There is no scholar who will agree with anything with another scholar. Go ahead, brother.
And when they tell you they disagree about any interpretation to any verse of the Quran, you have to take your brain out of your head and put it in a box and read for 15 minutes. Sometimes you get lost half of the reading because you don't know what you're talking about. And then when you finish, say, Alhamdulillah, Mashallah, and then you can put your brain back in your head. Why is that? Because you cannot imagine the disagreement. When they give you 19 interpretation for what is the Holy Spirit, and they give you 19 wrong interpretation, and they miss the one and true one, which is the Holy Spirit is the Spirit of God.
Yeah.
That's the one, amazing. So let's go back to the Shahada.
Yeah.
And quickly, I say, my dear Muslim friends, do not say the Shahada, because according to Islam, you're giving a false Shahada.
Exactly.
This Shahada is not true.
Yeah.
You say Ashhadu. What is Yashhad in Islam? I bear witness. You know what they teach me in America? Ashhadu in our textbooks all over our public schools now, as they teach me about Islam. Ashhadu an ilaha illallah, the Shahada. Muslims believe that there is no God except Allah and Muhammad is the Messenger. I'm sorry. Muslims do not believe. Muslims bear witness. When you bear witness, that means you have seen by your eyes, you have heard by your ear, you smell by your nose, you taste by your tongue, and you touch by your hand. If you don't have these five senses, which God Almighty gave to us, you are a false witness.
True story.
Try it in Sharia court. Forget about American courts. American courts, they laugh at you and they throw you out.
Yeah.
They literally consider you a contempt of court. You're going to go to bear witness of something you never heard. You
exactly.
Never smelled, you never touched.
Yeah, exactly. For example, let's say you are a witness of a crime scene. You saw someone in the dark, right? And he shoots the pistol and he kills somebody. The judge will ask you, hey, did you see something? Did you hear it? Did you see it? Did you see the gun go off? So when you say I bear witness, what kind of witness are you if you don't see, if you never saw Allah, you never saw Muhammad, you never saw Jibreel? What kind of witness are you?
but Khadija saw it. See, you have to understand, somebody witnessed for you. But anyway, I'm sorry, Khadija didn't saw it. Muhammad saw it. But here's the deal.
No, Khadija was only giving a striptease, my friend. Come on.
I'm telling you, brother. I'm telling you. But think about it. Think about it in Sharia, in Islamic law, for four witness for adultery.
Yeah.
You have to have four people have seen the private part of the man inside the private part of a woman.
You must basically trip and fall in, and still you need four witnesses, right?
Exactly.
Yeah, maybe it's you get an accident and then you trip and you fall in somebody's other wife, right? Somebody's wife. Maybe it can be an accident, right? Accidents can happen. But you still need four witnesses to see the action. And the action,
exactly,
between brackets,
because,
happen.
Because what if it was just lemon?
Yeah.
By the way, the only translation, I'm not bragging about my translation. I looked at all English translation for the Quran.
Yeah.
And not one of them explained to us what is lemon. Lemon, ladies and gentlemen, it is all what a man can do with a woman without having intercourse, and that's not adultery.
Yeah.
Two people naked, that's not adultery. Touching each other, not adultery. Receives the sexual intimacy, feelings, the orgasm, that's not adultery. Only when you have the private man inside the woman, okay? The private part of the man inside the private part of the woman. But, so, how complicated it is to have eyewitness in Islam? It's very complicated. I mean, can you imagine? You're stoning people, women, because she could not provide four eyewitnesses that she was raped.
Yeah, exactly.
She came in adultery.
And brother, can you remind me who the one is who agreed adultery, portion of adultery? Who was that again? Would agreed that on the Muslims?
I'm sorry, I don't understand your question.
According to the hadith, authentic hadith, sahih hadith, who is the one who decreed a portion of adultery on the Muslims? Who was that again?
I'm sorry, brother. Muhammad himself?
No, Allah. It says Allah decreed a portion of adultery on the Muslimin. So when you commit adultery...
Yeah. This is a authentic hadith, 100%.
Yes.
Before you even born, Allah have already made it for you. Everything is going. You're gonna go through, including the number of time you're gonna commit adultery.
Exactly.
I understand your question. I was missing it earlier.
Mm-hmm.
And by the way, not just the amount of how many time or who you will be have committed adultery with. Everything about a Muslim's life is determined at the age of 120 days old.
Yeah.
You have to understand now the stages.
Crazy.
Of babies made at the age of 120 days, that's when the man is now. He starts from Natfa to Alqa to Madgha. Now it's a Madgha, 120 days old, a piece of meat inside the mother womb. And then the angel will go inside the mother womb with a pen and a scroll.
Mm.
And he will ask Allah questions. Allah, do you want that thing here to be a man or a woman? He said, make it a man. Put it a man. Allah, will he be happy or miserable? Oh, happy. Okay, happy. Will he a believer or disbeliever? Disbeliever. Okay, disbeliever. And then in this scroll, everything, that piece of meat, 120 days old, everything will go through life, will be written. So it doesn't matter if Allah meant for me to be guided or to be not guided, to spend eternity in hell or to spend eternity in heaven, to kill or to commit adultery or to lie or to steal. All this is already written.
Exactly.
You have zero freedom to choose what to do.
The only thing, and this is why I always tell our audience, the only miracle in Islam is that there are over a billion poor deluded souls out there who believe that this is a truth from God. That's the only miracle in Islam. There is no miracles. Muhammad wasn't given any miracles. The only miracle is that people still believe that Islam is the truth. That's the only miracle, to be honest with you.
What about the miracle of the Quran, man? Haven't you know that the Quran is a miracle of Muhammad?
Yeah, for sure. Because Allah doesn't know that when we say God is father, that he didn't have sex with, let's say, Mary, God forbid. It's nothing but blasphemy.
I mean, it's logic, brother. How can Allah can have a son when he does not have a girlfriend?
Exactly. Allah must...
very important. You try. Anybody can try. If you can have a son without having a girlfriend, you prove to me that the Quran is wrong.
Yeah.
Okay?
Yeah.
Since Allah never have a girlfriend, he never has sahiba. So, he could not have a baby. Come on, man.
Brother Osama Dugdug, are you saying that we just proved that chapter 36, ayah 1, from all the tafsirs, that Allah is a human? On top of that, are you saying that Allah has a private part? And they say that la mithlihi shay', there's nothing like Allah. Clearly, Allah is a human and he is a private part. He can, if he wants, he can have sex with a girlfriend to have a son. But Allah is better than his prophet. I mean, Muhammad used to have sex slaves and he slept more than 50 women. All right, if we're going to go through the Muslim sources, we need 10 days to find all the names of the women, right? Because too many women in the life of Muhammad. Yep. But Allah is better than his prophet. Allah didn't want to have a girlfriend. Allah didn't want to have a sexual relationship with his sahiba.
Exactly. Sure. Because Allah is Allah.
Let me cliche, brother.
everything is set in a different set of measurement when you come to Allah. Anyway, brother, it was good talking to you. Appreciate you and appreciate your ministry.
Thank you, my friend. It's a blessing to have you.
Here's the truth. Thank you, brother. Here's the truth. We are not doing that. And I hope and I pray that none of us is doing that for the purpose of just mocking the Quran or mocking Muhammad or mocking Islam. We just want our Muslim friends to wake up before it's too late. Because you continue to believe in a lie and die believing in that lie, and then what you gain? You gain nothing.
Yeah.
Examine the things we share with you guys, our dear Muslim friends. Maybe we're just making it up.
Yeah.
Why don't you go there and examine and search and study? Enough is enough. It's been 1400 years Muslims raising Muslim babies and raising Muslim grandbabies, and nobody have a clue what is in Islam. Reason number one, why Muslims leave Islam? To know Islam. Or, you know what? After you study it and search it and you find the truth in it, well, praise God. I'm glad you're a Muslim. Stay in it. But don't believe in this empty box and you make this all this hollow of, the holy word of Allah. Stop washing your hand before you touch the Quran. Stop that. Because as long as you make the Quran the most holy thing, you will never read it, you will never understand it, and you believe in a lie. Just trust me. If the Quran is the holy, perfect word of Allah, it will make you unclean man a clean man. It will make you unclean woman a clean woman. Who have more power? Me over the word of Allah, or the word of Allah have power over me? Stop this. Take these glasses of Islam out and start reading the Quran to understand it. Don't memorize it. Understand it. You memorize in a joke. You know how many Muslim people I meet in my life, especially in Indonesia, who memorize the entire Quran in the Arabic language, and they do not know what good morning means in the Arabic language. They only know the Quran as they read it in the passages and memorize it as it is in the passage without having a clue what they are saying and what they're memorizing. Let us learn Islam. Let's investigate Islam. And if the truth is in it, hey, praise Allah. You're on the right track. If the truth is not in it, get out of it. Break the chain. People, free yourself and your children and grandchildren from that savage cult. Once again, thanks a lot, brother.
Thank you, brother.
God bless you.
And by the way, brother Osama, like before you go, brother, thank you again for calling and our brother, and I'm seeker too. Lord willing, if you have time, it would be amazing if one day you can join us and maybe you want to show some slides. We can do a live show together if you like.
It will be my joy, brother. It will be my joy. Sure. Just call
Let us have
me.
Some contact and we can share. And then, Lord willing, why not?
Adam will send it to you. Adam will have sure. all my permission. Amazing. Thanks a lot, brother. God bless you.
Thank you, my friend. Nice to hear you. God bless you.
Same here.
Have a
Bye-bye.
Nice day.
Thank you.
Thank you for your call.
Oh,
I closed the call. I think Adam Seeker wanted to say something. Let me call him back. Sorry for that, Adam. Sorry.
Hello.
Yeah.
Sorry, no worries. I hope you enjoyed, brother. Oh, man. Talk.
Yeah, that was amazing, bro. Thank you for being part of it. Yeah, and it would be amazing if one day he can join us. Maybe, you know, he want to do a presentation or something. That would be awesome to have this brother, amazing brother, a living legend who is doing this for many years, to be with him again. Amazing.
Amen.
Thank
amen.
You.
Amen. By the way, you guys were talking about Allah having a private part and Allah is being a man. I just sent you an image. If it's possible, show it on the screen because Allah has sperms as well.
Mm-hmm.
So Allah has sperms. So if you can show this image, because I don't want people to say that I am making this thing up.
No.
And I'm sending you the link as well so that the people would know what it is. So that nobody will say that we are talking a lie or something like that. This is Islam Web, not my website, Islam Web. And in this Islam Web, it says, فَيَرْسَلَ اللَّهَ مَعَ مِنْ تَحْتِهِ الْأَرْشِ كَمَنِيَ الرَّجَّالِ
كَمَنِيَ الرَّجَّالِ. Yeah, exactly. Yeah.
So under the arsh of Allah, under the throne of Allah, there is a sack in which Allah has water like the sperm of a rajal, of a human being, which he will send down as rain to human beings at the time of resurrection so that they will have body once again.
Yeah.
So if you go down a little,
let's see.
Scroll down a little. Yeah, there you go. Falaisa, stop. Falaisa, scroll up a little. Scroll one line up. One line up. Scroll one line up, brother.
This part, I think. Yes.
Yeah, brother.
Yeah.
Kala. Fayarsalallahu ma min tahti al arshika mani rajal fatanabast allaham wa jismah nahim. So this is how Allah will give them the body once again. So the purple line, this is what the purple line is saying.
Yeah.
Under the arsh of Allah,
if we copy this part, let's see if Google, peace be upon him, let's see what Google, you know, if it's not infiltrated by the Muslimin. Let's see what Google says, guys. Before, you know, here, then Allah sends water, semen. Allah sends semen from under his throne, like the men, the water of men. Do you see?
Yes.
The translation is a little bit strange, but you get the idea, right? So basically, if we can put it, let's say, in a picture, you know, I have many beautiful pictures, brother. Let's see if I can find a nice, beautiful picture, brother, for the Muslims. You see here, guys, I mentioned this on one of my live shows. Look, guys, like this. Allah sits on the throne. And even the hadith says that Muhammad will sit together with Allah on the throne. And maybe Muhammad will F Allah, I don't know. And you'll get semen from under the throne.
Allah will leak.
Allah will start to leak, brother.
No. Let's put it this way. Allah was doing nikahul laid, and he is collecting all his semen in the sack under the arsh.
Yeah, the people in the live chat are already taking out their umbrellas. They don't want to get wet. Understand.
Yeah, don't get wet, brothers. Don't get wet.
So make sure to have an umbrella because Allah will start to leak the moment Muhammad and Allah will sit. You know, maybe Muhammad will sit on the lap of Allah, and you know, because of that, the throne will start to leak, brother.
So, brother, this whole scenario is: you have Allah, who is insan, human. You have Allah, who has a private part because he doesn't have a sahiba.
Yeah.
And then you have Allah, who has a semen under his throne, which he's collecting by using masturbation, obviously, because nikah laid is okay because he doesn't have a female, so he's doing masturbation. And the last part is that he will make jism out of it. So the people who had died and they have bones now, so they'll be walking with bones only until the semen of Allah will be spreaded over them, and that semen is going to give them
brother
jism again.
Exactly. But again, this proves that Allah has a penis, and we proved it. Allah has a penis. Allah is a human. Yeah, insan. Oh, human. Allah has a penis, and Allah can leak. So, and Muslims tell us there's nothing like Allah. Well, Allah is a human being like you and me. He prays like you and me. Allah even has his own personal prayer. Allah even bow down like a human being. Allah is a human.
Absolutely. And brother, by the way, just for the people, because you need to give this links to the people. If you see this same story is written in Al-Qurtubi as well. I'm now sending you the link of the Qurtubi.
It's all over the place. It's very sahih, my friend. It's sahih.
Yeah. And this, if you go up, this is sahihain. If you go up, Scroll up to this link. The top, it says, the Sahihain, Kitabul Fathain wal Malahim, Zikr al Ahya'i al Maut wa Nufil Sawr. So this is the Sahihain, one of the Sahihain. Yeah. You can't reject.
Al Mustadrak ala al Sahihain. Exactly. You can see on top. So it's very Sahih. It's very, very Sahih, brother. Allah, for some reason, whenever Muhammad sits on the throne of Allah, Allah will start to leak. Maybe Allah gets excited or aroused by Muhammad. Allahu a'lam, brother. Allah knows best.
Allah knows best, yeah. Breasts are defined very accurately in Quran. So, yeah, Allah knows best.
Exactly.
So, brother, there is a Muslim who is in our live chat as well.
Okay, he wants to call?
He is coming up with 20 different names. And trying to say, Paul never saw Jesus. I want him to come up and show me, and I will show him when Paul actually saw Jesus and he got blinded because he was trying to persecute Christians. The scriptures are very clear. Now, he has to show me when Muhammad actually saw Allah.
Yeah.
Like, see, so I can show him exactly where it is written. Can he show me where Muhammad saw Allah? Because he is a shahada of Allah. Shahada Allahu.
Notice, brother, notice. We are talking about Allah. We prove over and over from the most authentic Islamic sources that Allah is a human being. What do Muslims do? They change. They want to change the topic. They are such little coward puppies. They need to change the topic. Attack the Bible because they have nothing. They can't defend Islam. They can't defend Allah. They can't defend the Quran. They can't defend a fraud, fake prophet, the most obvious fake prophet in history, Muhammad. So they need to change and tap dance and attack the Bible. We really pity you, ya Muslimin. Instead of defending the most obvious fake prophet in history, your prophet, you change the topic and you tap dance.
Exactly, exactly. And by the way, Quran is very clear, brother. Quran is very clear. Let me read a verse of Quran. Yeah. It says, Shahada Allahu annahu la ilaha illa huwa.
Yeah.
So basically, Allah is saying, Allah is bearing witness.
Allah is bearing
Allah
witness.
Allah is bearing witness. Who is bearing witness? This is Quran. Not Allah. Muhammad said, this is Quran. It says, Shahada Allahu annahu la ilaha illa huwa wa malaikatu wa ulul ilm. So Allah is bearing witness that there is no God but Him and angels and ulul ilm.
Exactly.
They do not translate it right. Because if you read Quran chapter 3 verse number 18, they make a full stop. But there is a wow. So, illa huwa wa malaikatu wa ulul ilm. So, basically, Allah is bearing witness that there is no God except Him and the malaika and the ulul ilm means and the people of the knowledge. So, for Muslimin, Allah is saying that their God is Allah and the malaika, the angels, and the people of knowledge. Is it me saying or Allah saying? This is Quran.
Yeah.
This is Quran. You can show it on the screen. Chapter number 3, verse number 18. You can show it on the screen so the people would know what I'm talking about. Because this is very important. Because the shahada which Muslims make is half shahada. The real shahada in Bukhari is different. Okay. The real shahada in Bukhari is different. I'm going to send you the shahada of the Muslimin in Bukhari, because in Bukhari you cannot find the shahada which Muslims recite, but you're going to find a different shahada. Let me give you the proper shahada in the link as well. There you go, brother. I'm sorry we are not in StreamYard, otherwise I could have shown all these. So Quran chapter number 3 verse number 18 is very clear. Shahada Allahu annahu la ilaha illa huwal malaikatuhu wa ulul ilm. So Allah is bearing witness that there is no deity except Him and the angels and those of knowledge. There is no comma, there is no nothing, there is no jim, there is no full stop. It's same. It's one sentence. Allah was either stupid in writing Arabic, or He does not know how to write Arabic, or Muslims do not know how to translate it. I have no idea what they are doing. But the real shahada, it is in Bukhari. The Bukhari, the shahada is, anyone testify that none has the right to be worshipped but Allah, who has no partner, and Muhammad is his slave and his apostle, and that Jesus is Allah's slave and his apostle, and his word which he bestowed on Mary, and a spirit created by him, and the paradise is true, and the hell is true, and Allah will admit him to paradise with deeds which has been done, even if those deeds are few. Now, imagine,
brother, just a second, can I interrupt you? There is a Muslim, her name is Samia Naeem. She's asking for that verse of the true Shahada. Can you again give us the chapter number? And
chapter number 3, Surah Al-Imran, chapter number 3, verse number 18.
Chapter 3, ayah 18.
Yes.
Surah Ali Imran, ayah 18.
And I'm not saying that. That's Allah saying she can go to any Arabic speaker. Yeah. And rather, you can open Sahih International Translation. Yeah. They actually put commas. So they put, but how they write it, they write
Let me actually put it on the screen for her. Surah Ali Imran.
Yes.
The family of Imran, ayah 18.
And go
do you see the screen, brother? Do you see the screen?
Yes, brother,
Okay, read it. So who is Allah bearing witness? Who is bearing witness? Allah, right?
Shahad Allah. Allah is bearing witness.
Let me put, you want Sahih International, you said?
Yes, brother, because Sahih International actually puts commas out of nowhere. I don't know where they find the commas. I have no idea how they found the commas in the Arabic. But anyhow, they put commas. So it says, Sahih International, Shahad Allah, Allah bear witness, that there is no deity, annahu la ilaha, there is no deity except him, illa huwa, and the angels, and...
Wait, brother, let us dissect it. I hope the sister, Samia, I hope you're watching, Samia. Look, it says huwa, this tiny letter here, let me make it a little bit bigger. Do you see here? This one says, and. Allah and the malaika, the angels. And who again, brother? And the people of the wisdom.
Knowledge.
Yeah, wisdom, the scholars. Knowledge. So who are the gods? Allah.
Allah.
The angels and the angels. Wa al-malaikatu. And the people of the
knowledge.
Knowledge, meaning the scholars. Thank you.
Man, how many gods they have now?
They have many. Muhammad chapter 48, ayah 9. Muhammad Isa chapter 9, ayah 31. Allah, the people of knowledge, the scholars, and the angels, Jibreel, for example, Mikael, Israfil, and Allah.
And all these
and the scholars,
Allahs, all these Allahs, what are they doing? They are Kaiman bil Kist. They are upholding the justice. Are you kidding me?
This is why Muslims don't question what scholars say or do, right? When a scholar gives his ruling, his fatwa, I mean, this is why Muslims always go back to their scholars. Whenever we ask Muslims question, they say, let me ask my sheikh. Now, do you understand why, guys? That's why.
Exactly, because the Arabic is very clear. Like brother, now tell me, except him, they put a comma. Can you find a comma in the Arabic? Is there a jim or something
you
like that?
You see everything that he is between brackets and so on. It's not there. It's not there. No brackets, no commas, nothing. It says here that Allah is bearing witness. I want to understand when Allah is bearing witness. To who is he bearing witness?
To the rest of the people.
That there is no God besides him. But it says, and the angels. So he's involving the angels and the people of the wisdom, meaning the scholars. So who are the deities in Islam? According to this ayah, Allah, the angels, and the scholars.
Yes, and they are maintaining the justice, man, on the land. They are Qaim al-Bilqist.
Exactly.
Imagine, brother, if this is written, if anything close to this would have been written in the Bible, what would they have done to us?
Yeah, my friend, this is not the only thing. Let me confirm, guys, let me confirm from the same chapter, actually, that the angels, the angels are actually God. Watch. If we go to chapter 3, just to confirm, you heard Adam Seeker and you heard me. We both can read Arabic. We understand Arabic. Let me confirm that actually Maryam, the Islamic Mary, not our Mary.
Called the angel Rab, is Kalat. Oh man. That is crazy.
Look.
Kalat Rabbi. Kala Rabbi.
Chapter 3, ayah 47. This is Mary in context talking. She said who? The Islamic Mary, Maryam, the mother of Isa. She said to who? To the angel. Qalat Rabbi. So the angel is her Lord. Rabbi in the Quran. Who is only Rab, my friend? According to the Quran, who is only Rab?
The angels, the Ulul Ilm, and Allah. We just read it.
So
and go to verses
only
first.
Only a God is called Rab. Rabbi. So she's saying to the angel, right?
My Lord.
You see, yeah, the angels are talking to her, right?
Exactly. Two verses before, Iskalat Malaikati. So she is talking to angels. Iskalat Malaikati. She's talking to angels. And then suddenly she said to the angels, my Rabb.
Qalat Rabbi. So she's addressing the angels as my Lord. Wow. Do you see how we just confirmed chapter 3, ayah 18? Chapter 3, ayah 47 confirms chapter 3, ayah 18 that the angels are God.
Exactly, brother. So, praise Lord, and thank you for your ministry, brother.
Thank you, my friend. God thank you bless for this you. Amazing call.
And and if a Muslim comes up, man, they need to come up.
Yeah,
they need to come up and explain this.
I'm waiting for them to call. Actually, call Muslims. Call.
I would ask your moderators, even though they are your moderators.
Yeah.
Do not block the Muslimin. Give them a timeout. Yeah. Let them be here. Let them listen.
No, they are not blocking them. They are not blocking them. They are only giving. If they cannot behave, they are only timing them out.
Yeah, because these Muslims are the ones who needs to come up and defend. Because when they come up and defend, they will leave Islam. That's the reality. They have no knowledge. The poor guys, these Muslims, the poor Muslims, they do not have knowledge. Once they seek the knowledge, once they open their brain, they leave this savage cult.
Yes, exactly. God bless you, brother Adam Seeker. Thank you for your call. Thank you also for allowing us to hear our brother Osama Dagduk on the call. Thank you for that again, brother. God bless your ministry. Nice to see you. Maybe we can do another live show soon, brother.
Amen, brother. Amen.
You know, it has been way too long. So maybe we can, if you want me on your live show, that would be amazing. You know, I would love to help out if possible, right? So
anytime,
keep this brother in your praise, guys. Keep this brother and also brother Osama Dagduk. Subscribe to his YouTube channel, also Osama Dagduk. And God bless you. Thank you for your call.
God bless you, brother. God bless
Thank you, Habibi. Bye-bye. That was Adam Seeker and that was Osama Dagduk. Wow, that was amazing, man. What a day. We have Abdurrahman leaving Islam, becoming a Christian. We have Rosemary, who left Islam, became a Christian. And today we have two amazing brothers who called us and did a lot of damage on the call. And you are my witnesses, guys. Is this good or what? And you guys go watch Netflix and Amazon Prime and whatnot, that garbage. Guys, small coffee break. I'll be right back. Don't go anywhere. Grab some popcorn, maybe some Pepsi, and we will continue just in a couple of minutes. Small coffee break, guys. Be right back.
Commercial break.
Hello, babies.
If you'd like to support Rob Christian, please go to Patreon and support. www.patreon.com/RobChristian. We thank you all for your kindly support and enjoy the video. Oh, and also, don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe. You know, it's free, Habibis. Don't be tight like Muhammad. Commercial break.
Hello, Habibis.
If you would like to support Rob Christian, please go to Patreon and support. www.patreon.com/RobChristian. We thank you all for your kindly support and enjoy the video. Oh, and also, don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe. You know, it's free, Habibis. Don't be tight like Muhammad. Commercial break.
Hello, Habibis.
If you would like to support Rob Christian, please go to Patreon and support.
All right. We are back, baby. We are alive, baby. We are back. What's up? Any Muslim in the house? Where is Mr. Rocky Balboa? Rocky Balboa, if you have any guts and you call yourself a man, right, and you claim to be a scholar, call me. I'm waiting for you to call. Call me. I mean, guys, if Rocky Balboa turns out to be a scholar, that means I'm Elon Musk. Yeah, I'm the owner of Tesla, brother. Yeah, Rocky Balboa claims to be a scholar. Where is he? Why is he hiding? Guys, I think it's the same idiot, John Wick, and you know, they have many nicknames. Adrian! Exactly. No Muslim? Guys, now let me go back to the main topic because I still need to prove. I still need to prove that according to Muhammad, this is Allah. Guys, look at my Photoshop skills, man. Man, look at my Photoshop skills, man. Allah looks like a human being and Muhammad is using him as his sock puppet. Yeah, you see, Allah is a young, beautiful man, brother. Remember, Allah is very beautiful, very sexy, brother, very healthy, very young. He has curly hair and he wears a green suit. I mean, if this is not sahih Photoshop skills, then I have no idea what Photoshop means, brother. Look at this, man. Guys, this is copyrighted, okay? This is copyrighted. If I catch you selling my painting, I will sue you. Yeah, hello?
Hello?
Yeah, hello, Sammy. Welcome. You're live on air.
Thank you. How are you?
I'm good. What about you? Are you Muslim? What are you exactly?
Yes, I am Muslim.
You're a Muslim. Okay, you're a Muslima.
Yeah, I'm Muslima.
Okay, welcome. What do you want to say to us?
Actually, I have one question, but that question I should ask to Muslim scholars too, because like I heard they keep on telling us that Jesus was not crucified and he was one of the deceiver actually. So my question.
What one of what? Can you please repeat what you?
One of the deceivers, like who deceived him?
Who deceived who?
to Jesus.
Someone deceived Jesus, the Islamic Jesus?
Because they did. Wow. Yeah, I heard the story that they deceived.
That's new.
Jesus.
Okay.
Yeah, in a way that because of because they doesn't want Jesus to be there, so one of the disciple, he was not actually a disciple, but was in there with Jesus, and he deceived him, and so God actually switched and turned his face into Jesus, and God raised
but
him.
But where does this the deception come from? I think from Allah, right? The Mecca.
Yeah.
Okay, so you agree that Allah is the best of deceivers, right?
That's in Quran also, Makrullah.
So if Allah is the best deceiver, and you just confirmed it, sister. What does that make Satan? If Allah is the best deceiver, what does that make Satan in Islam, according to the Quran? Mm. If Allah is the best deceiver, Allah deceives people. And you said Allah deceived Isa. What does that make Satan? It means Satan must look for another job then. If Allah is the best deceiver, right?
Yeah, Allah doesn't deceive Isa.
But you said it. I didn't say it. Yeah, those are your words.
He did that to the deceiver, actually.
So Allah deceived the deceivers.
Yeah.
That's what you're trying to say.
Yeah, my question is not complete here. Where the question comes, where okay, if he really deceived the deceiver and he switched his face or he turned his face into Jesus, he was crucified. He was crucified on the cross. So where is his body? If it was really, because according to our Muslim, Jesus were not crucified and God raised him up and all that. So okay, if we really believe in that, so where is the body of that deceiver who actually got switched to that?
But wait, sister, let us go back. Let us go back a little bit. If Allah is the one who is deceiving, وَمَكَرُوا وَمَكَرَ اللَّهُ وَاللَّهُ خَيْرُ الْمَاكِرِينَ Allah is the best deceiver. And you see, this is false translation. Because else the text, the Arabic text would have said, مخطط muqtatin, meaning the planners. This is false translation. The text says Allah is the best of al-makirin, meaning Allah is the best of deceivers. That's the correct Arabic translation. So if Allah is the best deceiver, and you confirmed it, what does that make Satan in Islam? If Allah is the best in deception, that means Satan is out of job. Maybe Satan must go and look for a new job, right? Because Allah is better than him in deception. So why are you still a Muslima if you must believe that Allah is the best deceiver? So who is the real Satan? Iblis or Allah?
You are so confused.
Okay, I understand. Been there, done that, and many people like you should be confused, sister. So I advise you to leave this satanic cult of Satan. I mean, the true Satan, Allah, who claims to be the best deceiver. Leave Islam. What is holding you back? Say it. Since you basically left Islam. You just said it, basically, right?
Yeah, I'm still practicing. I'm still praying. I'm still doing everything.
No, sister. You just said Allah is the best deceiver. And you agreed with me. You didn't say no. You agreed with me that Allah makes Satan look like a clown regarding deception. Allah is the real deceiver. The best deceiver. So why are you calling the true Satan, who is nobody else than Allah, why are you calling him your God? Are you a Satanist? Do you like to be a Satanist? Or do you want to leave this satanic cult and come back home to Jesus? You're almost out. You're almost out. Don't fear anyone, sister. Care about your soul.
I don't fear anyone. I am praying. I'm praying to show God to show me the truth because I have kids.
But you are praying to who? To what God? Are you praying to Satan, Allah?
So I'm not saying Allah because.
So to who do you pray then when you say I pray? To who do you pray?
So when I heard that Allah told Moses that my name is Yahweh. So
you're praying. Wait, are you saying that you're praying to the God of the Bible?
Well, I believe God gave the name to Moses was the correct name.
Okay, so why are you still a Muslim? Say it. I'm not a Muslim anymore. Say it. Don't be scared. Since you are praying to the God of the Bible, why are you a Muslim? Why are you calling yourself a Muslim?
I'm not scared. I'm not scared. Once I will agree 100% and totally, I will openly announce
it. Sister, you already left Islam. You just said it. You're praying to the God of the Bible. We showed everybody that the God of the Bible is not the same God of the Qur'an. The God of the Qur'an is Satan himself. He's the best deceiver. He's the best of deceivers. He claims to be Satan himself. So God of the Bible is love. But God of the Qur'an is Satan, who is the best of deceivers. So say it. Don't be scared. Say it. Come on, sister, you're laughing. That means you're out. Say it. You're laughing. I know what that means. I wasn't born yesterday. Say it. Come on. Say I'm out of this cult. Muhammad is a false prophet. Say it.
I will.
Say it, sister. Come on, say it. No, say it. Come on. When you're laughing, we know the meaning of laughing. That means you're not even taking Islam serious anymore.
Oh, somebody's saying I'm fishy.
Say it. I'm out of this garbage. Say it.
No.
Yeah. I know inside of you, you are all dead.
I'm searching.
Searching for what? You're searching for what?
Searching for the right path, searching for the truth.
But you're already praying to the God of the Bible. You said it earlier.
Yes.
So you already found. You found the true God, and you are actually, in your heart, you already left Allah, Satan of the Quran. You already left him. Because you're praying to the God of Moses of the Holy Bible. Say it. I mean, only the words. I mean, in your heart, you already left. Say the words. Nobody is putting a gun on your head. It's your freedom. It's your choice. It's your salvation. It's your soul, sister. Just say it. Sister, humanity, why not now?
No.
You're already laughing. You yourself called Allah the best of deceivers. You're already out. Just confirm it. Say it. Say it.
I'll
talk to your channel. No. Okay. What do you want to say to the people? How can I convince you more? What kind of questions that are bothering you? Can we help you here since you are already on the call? What is holding you back? What is that tiny little thing? Because you're saying no, I don't want to say it. What is that tiny little thing that we can cut off for you to actually say you're out of this garbage?
I don't know. It's not easy. I'm still confused. I'm scared.
Okay, give us an example. What is your confusion about? I want to help you. We are here anyway. We have all the time of the world. We have more than 300 people watching.
I know I'm confused with the both thing. If
with what?
Like our scholar says not to go through the Torah and Injil and
why
like
would Bible. Why would they say that? Why?
And the Quran just said that if you have any confusion, you can go back and look to the books. I know this.
So that's we have a contradiction. Wait, your yes. Quran in chapter 10, I believe that's ayah 94. Your Quran is saying, go to the people of the book if you are in doubt. I am people of the book, right? The Quran calls me people of the book. So if you are in doubt, you come to me. Your prophet had to go to the Jews and the Christians if he was in doubt. Muhammad started to doubt, right? So Allah told him, go to the people of the book because they received the scripture, the Holy Bible, before him. So your scholar are saying, no, that's a lie. So do you see how your scholars are calling Allah a liar? Because this is Quran. So your scholars are not even a real Muslims. Even your scholars are calling the Quran of Allah, Allah himself and Muhammad, liars. So you see how I'm helping you here, sister? So if you have questions, if you are in doubt, you called me. I didn't ask you to call me, right? You called me out of your free will because you are in doubt. You have confusion. You said it. Everybody heard you. So you see, I'm helping you with your confusion because I am people of the book. I know the language. I know Arabic. I can dissect the Quran. Clearly, the Quran is claiming that Allah is Satan because if Allah is the best of deceivers. Problem. Yeah, sorry.
That's our problem that we do not because my basic language is Urdu. I memorize and all that. So I just take an advanced classes of Arabic where I just know the meaning of Arabic. So whoever our teachers told us, we said, okay, this is what they are telling. That's true.
Yeah. You see, and since Allah is a deceiver, that means actually the crucifixion of Jesus did happen on the cross. Here, look, sister, this is the next ayah. Let me put the correct translation for you just to help you, okay? Since you are in doubt and since the Quran tells you, commands you to go to the people of the book. Look, sister. This is, can you see the screen? Can you see the screen?
Yeah.
Okay, look. Surat Ali Imran, same chapter, just the next ayah. Ayah 55. Recall what time Allah said, O Isa, this is the Islamic Jesus, verily I shall make thee what? Die. And the word is mutawafika. If we go to Ibn Abbas, the cousin of Muhammad, he explains that mutawafika means maut. Mumituka. You know Urdu, right? Urdu is looks like Arabic, right? Look, sister. Let me put that part also on the screen. Just to confirm for you that we are not lying. We are people of the book. We know what we are talking about. And your Quran even commanding you to go to the people of the book. Look. If we go to Ibn Abbas, this is what? Here is Sahih Bukhari, sister. Sahih Bukhari, you see it?
Mm-hmm.
Sahih al-Bukhari, volume 6. And I put the page from Sahih al-Bukhari, look. This is the page of Sahih al-Bukhari, look on top. Sahih al-Bukhari, can you confirm?
Now I can see.
You can see, right?
Yeah, now
I can. Okay, what does it say here? Waqala ibn Abbas, do you see it? Waqala ibn Abbas, the cousin of Muhammad. Mutawafika in chapter 3, ayah 55 means what? Mumituka. You know what maut is in Urdu, right?
Yeah, I know.
What does that mean? Please translate.
The The moth.
What does moth mean? Ibn Abbas says mutawafika means mumituka. What is moth in Urdu?
When someone died, it's moth.
So the Quran just said, according to Ibn Abbas, the Quran said that the Islamic Isa did die. So why are you still a Muslim? Do you see that how the scholars have lied to you?
Yeah.
Because the Sahaba, Ibn Abbas himself confirms that the Islamic Isa did die.
I know these words and they put that into a future tense.
They lie because it says he's already dead. And Allah takes him to himself. Look, we go back to the ayah, sister. Look, recall what time Allah said, O Isa, verily I shall make thee die. Mutawafika, a mumituka, maut, meaning death. And I am lifting thee to myself. So Allah is the reason why Isa died. And Allah then takes him to the same place where he is. Do you see it? So Isa died and Allah takes him to himself. So why are you still a Muslim? Say it. Say I'm out of this garbage. Say it.
I will say, I don't know.
Say it,
now.
Sister. Come on, say it. Don't be afraid. Don't do it for me. Do it for yourself.
I know. That's what I'm
saying. Say it.
Now. I have to do it for myself.
Yeah. Do you care about yourself? Be honest. Do you care about yourself?
Yes, I do care more than because I have kids.
Okay. So you care about yourself. You have kids. You should care about yourself and you should care about your kids. Your kids are very precious to you, right? Don't you want you and your kids to be saved? Don't you want to join all of us here, all the Christians? All the Christians here. Don't you want to join us and be alive for the rest of eternity? Be with God again? Reunited with God again? Not with Satan, I mean Allah, who claimed to be the best of deceivers? Say it, sister, for your salvation, for your kids.
I will, but I'm not.
Say it.
No.
Okay, maybe if you are ready, you can call me again. I'm Abdurrahman. Look, sister, Abdurrahman, he called me and we had a couple of conversation the other day. And he, you know, after 3 hours, he could not, you know, he called me again and then he said, I left Islam. Then today he sent me a message and I put it on the screen. He said, Rob Christian, it was really hard. But after 2 weeks, I had no other option than to become a Christian. So you're not the first, sister. You're not the last. The internet is destroying this satanic cult.
I am being looking at the, especially the testimony of the Muslims who convert to Christianity. And that always gave me a goosebumps when I heard them.
Just look, if you go back, sister, let me give you a couple of examples. If you go back to my YouTube channel, I have a created playlist. If you go to the playlist, I have many people who called us and we put it in small video clips. People who left Islam and they became Christians on our live show. You're not the first, sister. You're not the last. Say it.
I know. Not I will. Maybe I will be there in your list too. But right now.
Okay, no problem. Call me when you're ready, okay?
Okay, sure.
Okay, sister. Keep watching. Keep watching our live streams. We love you. We do not hate you, sister. You are a sister in humanity, but we want you to become a sister in Christ so we can be happy with one another and reunite again with the real living God of the Holy Bible that you are praying to. You said it.
Yeah. I got a lot of answers with one of your video that you put on for on Surah Kahf. Yeah. That was amazing and shocking for me too.
So you're actually, I'm already sensing that you are out, but you for some reason you don't want to say it, but in your heart you're already out. Everybody, we are not stupid. We already sense it. And you're laughing and you know this is evil. This cult is evil. You know it. Islam cannot be from the living God. And sorry for the background noise, my son just came home with his mom. Yeah. So, sister, any last words before we let you go?
thank you so much. And please, I said that in the CP stream too. Just pray for me. I know you guys are praying.
We'll keep you in our prayers, sister. We do not hate you.
Nice friends here too, the Christian friends who actually opened my eyes and actually give me that spot where I can open my mind and I can dig into this. Before that, I don't want to listen.
Exactly. You see, this the only thing is what we are asking sincere Muslims like you. You sound like a very humble, very respectful sister in humanity. We only are asking you to use your brains. That's it. Think. Right? We are showing everybody everything on the screen and we ask this the right questions. We ask the right questions and we're showing everybody how the scholars are lying. They lie about the Quran. They actually contradict Muhammad. They contradict the Quran. I truly believe if Muhammad would be alive today, he would not deny that Jesus died on the cross. He would not deny it. And I can show you even that Muhammad became the prophet of Satan, if you like. I can show you from Sahih, from three different Sahih hadiths, that Muhammad became the prophet of Satan. You like? You want me to show you? Maybe that will convince you. If I can show you, would you leave Islam?
Not now. I already seen a lot of hadith, and I took a screenshot also, and I shared one with my husband too. And he was like, "Why are you? I don't know why you are just listening to this. I don't know why you are doing." I said, "God, why God gave us a brain to listen and to see?" So he was like kind of upset why I'm doing.
Sister,
all this.
Look at this. Here is a book. This is written by a very, very famous scholar in Islam. His name is, the book is called Majma' al-Zawa'id. Very, very famous book in the Arab world. Majma' al-Zawa'id wa Manba' al-Fawa'id. Volume 7, page 115. Imam al-Haythami. If we go to his book, this is the reference. Okay. This is the reference. If we go to his book, we see this page. And it says here that Muhammad, when he was in Mecca, and the hadith is sahih, look, وَرِجَالَهُمَّ رِجَالُ الصَّحِيحِ. So everybody in the chain are the people of the men of the as-sahih, like Sahih Bukhari, like Sahih Muslim. So the hadith is very sahih, okay? It says here that when Muhammad was in Mecca, وَكَانَ بِمَكَّةَ. So Muhammad was in Mecca, and Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was in Mecca. فَقَرَأَ سُورَةَ النَّجْمِ. So Muhammad started to read, to recite Surat An-Najm, which is chapter 53 of the Quran. And then, look what it says. Then when he reached, أَفَرَأَيْتُمَ اللَّاتَ وَالْعُزَّ وَمَنَاتَ ثَالِثَةَ الْأُخْرَى. Meaning chapter 53, ayahs 19 and 20. Then Satan, فَجَرَ عَلَى نِسَانِهِ. Satan put on his tongue, تِلْكَ الْغَرَانِيقَ الْعُلَى الشَّفَاعَ مِنْهُمْ تُرْتَجَى. These are the satanic verses here, right here that you see here. So Allah not helping Muhammad, Allah not protecting Muhammad from Satan, and Muhammad not realizing that these are the words of Satan. And then, look what it says here. Muhammad, that day, became a mushrik, and he bowed down to Allah, Al-Uzza wal-Manat. What do you think about this? And this is sahih. Muhammad that very day become the prophet of Satan. So if your prophet became mushrik, and we know that shirk is the unforgivable sin in Islam.
Can you share the reference again? I just want to take a screenshot.
Here is the reference. This is the book, page 115, volume 7. Imam al-Hafiz al-Haythami is the scholar. And if this is not enough, have you ever heard of Jalaluddin al-Suyuti, sister, who wrote Tafsir al-Jalalain?
No.
Tafsir al-Jalalain, you never heard of this?
Nope.
Okay, let me put this one. This is reference number 2. Look, sister, take another screenshot.
Okay.
This is reference number 2. Adhur al-Manthur. By Jalaluddin al-Suyuti, who wrote Tafsir al-Jalalain for the Quran. Same guy, giant scholar in Islam, Sunni scholar. Volume 10, in his book Al-Dhurr al-Manthur, pages 525 to 532. We see again, Sahih Hadith, look. Page 525. tafsir for Surah Al-Hajj. Look, chapter 22, ayah 52 to ayah 55. The isnad in the chain of narration, the people are in the chain, are trustworthy. Look, بِإِسْنَادٍ رِجَالَهُ ثِقَاتٍ, meaning all the men in the chain are trustworthy. And here in, on the bottom, again, the isnad sahih. In the bottom, وَرِجَالَهُمَّ رِجَالَ الصَّحِيحِ. The isnad, the chain is sahih. What does it say? What does it say? Look. What does it say? Again, that man Muhammad was in Mecca. This is from Ibn Abbas. An Ibn Abbas. Inna Rasulullah qara'a. Afra'aytum al-lata wal-uzza wa manat al-thalithat al-ukhra. And then Satan cast on his tongue. Tilka al-gharaniq al-ula wa inna shafa'atahunna la turtaja. These are the satanic verses, sister. Muhammad not realizing that Satan put satanic verses on his tongue. Uh-oh. And here is my translation, sister. Here. Look. Maybe you want to take screenshot of the. This is my translation because, unfortunately, the Arabic is not translated. Muslim scholars don't dare to translate because many Muslims like you will leave Islam. Like Abdurrahman, they will leave Islam. Look. Look. Do you see it?
Yeah, when I try to see to my screen, I have to play, then I heard you double voices, so I couldn't hear you properly. Then.
Yeah, again. These are the high cranes Satan cast on Muhammad's tongue. These are the high cranes, the gharaniq, the idols of Mecca. And their intercession is hoped for. The Quraysh said, Muhammad did not mention our idols specifically until today. Muhammad then did sujood, and all of the people that were present there, that day became mushrikeen. They said, Muhammad did sujood. He prostrated to the idols. Muhammad, your prophet, became a mushrik. Can you remind me? Can Allah forgive shirk in Islam?
No.
So Muhammad became a mushrik. He did sujood. He worshipped the idols. Allat al-Uzza wal-Manat. So why are you a follower of a mushrik pagan prophet? Tell me, please. I want to learn from you. And you see here, the isnad is sahih. We showed you. Look, sister, we go back. Look. The isnad sahih. You see it? What do you want more? So why, again, why are you still a Muslimah if your own prophet became a mushrik and you just confirmed that shirk is unforgivable? So according to Islam, Muhammad is now burning in hellfire. Your prophet is burning in hellfire because if we have to go by the logic of Islam, Allah will not forgive Muhammad.
Yeah.
And even Jibreel says, look what Jibreel says. Then Jibreel came to him after that and said, I, Jibreel, did not bring you this. These are the satanic verses. This is from Satan. And Muhammad did sujood. Do you see it? Muhammad did sujood.
Wow. I don't know. I never heard this. I never saw this.
You see, when we listen to the Muslims who do not read the books like you, Muslims always repeat what the lying scholars say, what the imams say. Imams say this is satanic verses are fabrication, right? That's what they always say. But when we go and read the Islamic books, we see that they are not fabrication. They are actually sahih. Look. بِإِسْنَادٍ sahih. وَرِجَالَهُمَّ رِجَالَ sahih. Everybody in the chain are the people of the Bukhari, Muslim. Highly trustworthy. إِسْنَاد is sahih. So again, why do you want to be a Satanist? Why don't you want to become a Christian? What is holding you back?
I'll call you again.
All right. You took screenshots, right? Take a screenshot
again.
Yeah,
I did. I took all right. Screenshots. I'm taking all of screenshots. Yeah. I know one in my family. I will show this to her.
Yeah. All right, sister. We will keep you in our prayers. We do not hate you.
Yeah,
you are a dear sister in humanity. We just want you to become a sister in Christ. That's all.
I know.
God bless you. God bless you. May our Lord open your eyes for the truth, sister. And I will ask everybody in the live chat to pray for this amazing woman. God bless you. May our Lord and Savior open your eyes. And I hope, I'm waiting for a call from you on my next live show, or maybe the live show after that. Call me. Don't hesitate. Call me. And if you're ready, say it. All right?
I will. Thank you.
All right, sister. Thank you for calling.
Bye.
God bless you. Bye-bye. What can we do? We can do more than that, right, guys? You see, I tried. But if, you know, guys, again, Rome was not built in one day. Yes, hello?
Hello?
Yeah, hello, you're live on air. Are you a Muslim?
Yes.
All right, welcome. You're live on air. Go ahead.
Shlonech.
I'm good. What about you?
Good, my friend.
Welcome. Yes? Go ahead. You're live on air.
Yeah, what's your question?
My question is, why are you still a Muslim if your prophet was a prophet of Satan?
What do you mean a prophet of Satan?
Well, it's in front of you. Look. Look at. Can you see the screen, my friend? Can you see the screen?
Bisanadin Sahih. Wait.
No, look at the screen. This is the reference, Adhur al-Manthur. You know Jalal al-Din al-Suyuti, right?
Yes.
Can you tell us who Jalal al-Din al-Suyuti is?
He's a big scholar.
Very big scholar, right?
Yeah, very big.
Okay. In his book, this is the book, Adhur al-Manthur, volume 10, page 525, all the way to page 532. When we open the book, we see that we come to a shocking information in this very book. Look, this is the book of Adhur al-Manthur by Jalal al-Din al-Suyuti, volume 10. We find this hadith. Actually, we find two hadith. The first hadith says that the people in the chain are trustworthy. Can you confirm?
Yes.
Can you read and translate this highlighted here with red?
1 second, because I'm on my phone.
Okay. Take your time. No problem.
وأخرج البزار والطبراني وابن وابن مر مردوي مر how do you read that?
You know Arabic, right? You call me. You have an Arabic name. Don't tell me you don't know Arabic.
Yeah, but it's complicated.
Anyway, okay. Continue reading. What does it say here? This part here. Forget about it. What does that mean?
It means a chain with trustworthy people.
Trustworthy, highly trustworthy people, right? So all the men in the chain are trustworthy.
Yes.
Okay, we scroll down. What does it say here in the bottom? What does it say here?
Bisanadin Sahih.
Okay, what does that mean?
Strong chain, Sahih. It's
very, very, and here in the bottom, what does it say?
وَرِجَالُهُمَا رِجَالُ الصَّحِيحِ.
So very, very, very authentic, right?
Yes.
Okay, now read and translate. Read from here and okay, we read that part. Okay, then start reading from here and translate.
إِنَّ رَسُولَ اللَّهِ صَلَّى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمَ.
Wait, before you skip, who is reporting it? Ibn Abbas, right? Cousin of Muhammad.
Yes.
He said, قَالَ. So Ibn Abbas said, قَالَ. إِنَّ رَسُولَ اللَّهِ. Okay, continue.
أَفَرَأَيْتُمُ اللَّاتَ وَالْعُزَّى وَمَنَاةَ الثَّالِثَةَ الْأُخْرَى.
Okay. Okay, what these are the satanic verses, right?
Yes.
تِلْكَ الْغَرَانِيقَ الْعُلَى وَإِنَّ شَفَاعَتَهُنَّ لَتُرْتَجَى. So Muhammad, in other words, when he's reciting Surah An-Najm and he reaches ayahs 19 and 20, Satan cast on his tongue, أَفْرَأَيْتُمَ اللَّاتَ وَالْعُزَّى. Right? تِلْكَ الْغَرَانِيقَ الْعُلَى وَإِنَّ شَفَاعَتَهُنَّ. These are the exalted idols, the crane, yeah, the غَرَانِيقَ. And their intercession is hopeful, right?
So why did your God create Satan?
You want to change topic now? Wait, let us finish this. Just a second. Why are you following a prophet who worshipped idols and did not know the difference between Quran and satanic verses and did not know the difference between Jibreel and Satan? Answer the question, please. And why are you still a Muslim?
I'm not that kind of Muslim, you know.
What kind of Muslim are you? You only follow a satanic prophet?
Not in everything.
So sometimes you follow a satanic prophet like Muhammad, and sometimes not?
It's a
hobby. There. So Islam is a hobby for you.
Yeah, but tell me, why did your...
Tell me. Okay, waste of time. Tell me, brother, tell me. The guy doesn't know what just hit him, and he wants to change topic. Carl, you're stuck, man. Poor guy is stuck. He's stuck. Tell me. So sometimes, brother, he follows a satanic prophet, Muhammad. Sometimes he doesn't. Hobby, brother. Islam is a pure, you know, game in the hands of Muslims. Do you hear? Let me give him a chance, guys. Let me give him another chance. Yeah. Something happened, brother. I think you forgot to say inshallah. Did you say inshallah before you called me?
I forgot.
Oh, you forgot. Okay. So again, here's the question. Why do you follow a prophet who delivered satanic verses and he did sujood to the idols of the Quraysh? Allat al-Uzza wal Manat. Why are you calling him a prophet?
It's cultural.
It's cultural to worship idols like Muhammad and get away with it? But doesn't Islam say shirk is the unforgivable sin?
Yes, but actually God forgives anything.
God forgives unforgivable sin?
He forgives shirk too. If you look carefully in the Quran, you will find that he
Allah forgives shirk?
Yes, it's in the Quran.
Allah forgives shirk? Guys, no waste of time. Please never ever call me again. Please don't ever call me again. Waste of time. Don't call me. You're a troll. I have no time for trolls, guys. I really don't have time for such trolls, to be honest with you. Let me block this troll. He's a troll, man. Suddenly, shirk can be forgiven. Is there any other Muhammadan? Allah forgives shirk, brother. Allah, did you hear it, guys? Allah forgives shirk. Unforgivable shirk becomes forgivable. This is the logic of the Muslim. I have nothing to do with this, guys. It's recorded. You heard it, right? Since when does Allah forgive shirk? Allah forgives shirk? Wow. Guys, you see, guys, what kind of savages they are? You see how that they have no honor and no dignity? They need to lie. This guy never seen this hadith before. He doesn't know what hit him. So the only thing he can do is lie without any shame. Allah forgive sins. Allah forgive Muhammad for sin, for shirk. Any other Muslim guys? Any other Muhammadan? Anyway, let us continue, guys. The Prophet said, this is Allah. Allah looks like this, brother. And this is Muhammad, brother. And Allah is the hand puppet. Allah, Muhammad puts his in the back of Allah. Allah looks like this. Very young, handsome, brother. Curly hair. And he wears a green suit. Prove it, Rob. Well, there you go. قال النبي صحيح. صحيح حديث. قال النبي رأيت ربي في صورة شاب أمرد. في سورة شاب أمرد, meaning the Prophet said, I saw my Lord in the image of a young man with curly hair wearing a green suit. Take a screenshot, guys. I saw, Muhammad said, I saw my Lord Allah in the image of a young man with curly hair wearing a green suit. So according to Muhammad, this is how Allah would look like. See? Muhammad is putting Allah very high, brother. Look, this is Allah, brother. I mean, look at my Photoshop skills, guys. Again, this is copyrighted. If you steal my images, I will sue you, Christians. Yeah, I created this in Photoshop, guys. Good or what? Come on, man. Yeah, this is Allah, man. Rob, can you give us the reference? Sure, why not? Here is the reference. Here's the link, guys. If you scroll on this page that I just gave you, Here are the references. And the hadith is sahih. Okay, sahih. And you can find this hadith in multiple books. Many books. This hadith. Oh, for some reason. Okay, I see that link, guys. Sorry for that. I need to give you a shorter link. Just a second. Because the Arabic, when you have a link, it contains Arabic words, it does not work. Oh, we have an idiot who needs to spam the live chat. Bunch of idiots, man. Block him, guys. Block him. Just block him. Okay. Look, guys, this is the link again. Right? Of this page here. And if you want to take a screenshot, this is my translation. Again, Muhammad said, Ra'aytu Rabbi fi surati shabban amrad. Muhammad said, I saw my Lord in the image of a young man with curly hair wearing a green suit. Yes, hello, you're live on air. Cannons are up, you got struck up, the strokes lead. So rap the nigga playing thugs, try to post. You kill that nigga, but I remember was a shot for his stoji. You see big guns, oh yeah. It's haunting, it gets deep, fucking with the idiot. Bunch of idiots, man. Bunch of idiots, man. What's wrong with you, Muslims? And you see, he's playing a song with the word, with the N word, right? They need to. Bunch of racists. He's a racist like his prophet. Now, guys, let me talk about something else. Since we just proved to everybody that Allah looks like a young man with curly hair. Curly hair, wearing green suit. Look what it says here. Sahih al-Bukhari hadith. Let me give you the link. Guys, focus, guys, focus. Wasn't music haram, brother? Wasn't music haram? Anyway. Narrated Abu Hurairah, Sahih al-Bukhari hadith number 6227. Narrated Abu Hurairah, the Prophet said, Muhammad said, Allah created Adam in his image, in his picture. He's 60 cubits tall in height, meaning about 30 meters. So Allah and Adam look the same. Allah created Adam in his image. Okay. Now if we go to the Qur'an, guys, remind yourself this. Allah created Adam in his image, and Adam is 60 cubits. Meaning Allah and Adam are evenly tall, right? Allah and Adam are 60 cubits. Cubit, guys, is length of a forearm. The length of a forearm. Dira. In Arabic, that's dira. So Allah and Adam are equally tall. Okay, Rob, where do you want to go, Rob, with this? Wait, just wait. Bear with me, please. If we go to the Quran in chapter 5, ayah 22, Surah Al-Ma'idah, ayah 22, and we go to the tafsir of this ayah, let me go to the tafsir together with you, we find a story about this part here. This is tafsir. Let me go back here on top. Tafsir Ibn Kathir, same chapter, same ayah. We scroll down. Tafsir Ibn Kathir. Let me give you the link. Guys, bear with me, please. We read that there is a guy called Auj. Let me give you this word here. This word here means Auj. This is a name. Auj. Okay, this word here is Auj. Auj bin Anq. And he is the son of Ibn Bint Adam. So he's the grandson of Adam himself. Guys, Auj is the son of the daughter of Adam. So Adam is the grandfather of Auj. I have nothing to do with this, but this is Tafsir Ibn Kathir. Chapter 5, ayah 22. He is the son of the daughter of Adam. Okay, what do you want to say, Rob? If we continue reading, it says that this Auj, this same Auj, guys, please focus. Ouch, the grandson of Adam, is 3,300, his length is 3,333 1/3. We copy this part and we put it here. Read with me, guys. Ouch ibn Anaq, the son of the daughter of Adam, meaning the grandson of Adam. His length is 3,000 cubits, 333 cubits, and 1/3 cubit. Meaning 3,333. If I'm not mistaken, this is the way to, 3,333.33. That's his length in cubits. All right. Now let us do a math. Guys, let us go back to school. Let us teach the Muslims how to calculate. If Ouch's length is 3,333 arms, cubits, four arms, and Allah's length is 60 cubits, we do divide that, right? Let us divide these numbers. We see that Ouch, the grandson of Adam, is 55 times bigger than Allah himself. And Muslims say, Allahu Akbar. Wait, Ouch is 55 times, at least 50 times bigger than Allah. But Muslims say, Allahu Akbar. They say, Allahu Akbar. Allah is the biggest. Allah is bigger. Wait a second. Ouch is bigger than Allah. Guys, Ouch, the grandson of Adam, is bigger than Allah. Meaning, Allah is not Akbar. Ouch is Akbar. Ouch is Akbar. Do you see it? Take a screenshot. I gave you the links. Tafsir ibn Kathir, chapter 5, ayah 22. Ouch, the grandson of Adam, is bigger than Allah. 55 times bigger than Allah. Yet Muslims dare to say Allahu Akbar. A'udhu billah. Yeah. I have nothing to do with this. This is Quran. Yeah, they should say, Ouch, Hu al Akbar, not Allah. Uh-oh. So guys, this is Ouch. Just a second. This is Ouch. Let's say this is Ouch. He is bigger than Allah. 50 times, more than 50 times bigger than Allah. Yes, hello?
Sexy and I know it.
Thank you. Playing Christian Prince video clips. See how many trolls there are, guys? See these savages? Yeah, Allah is sexy. Look, guys, Allah is sexy and he knows it. Exactly, brother. Brother Thista, exactly. Exactly. Allah is sexy and he knows it. Yeah, exactly. Allah is sexy, but he's not Akbar. Ouch is Akbar, and Allah is a very puny, tiny God. If the grandson of Adam, Ouch, is 55 times bigger than Allah, and guys, I know this is the first time that you've seen this, you're shocked, all right? I was shocked when I saw this, guys. This is the first time that I read this before. This is the very first day that I'm sharing this online with everybody. So you see, guys, the more we take deep dives like Yasser Qadi, all right, we will find more shocking facts in this cult, in the Islamic books. Turns out that Ouch is 55 times bigger than Allah. 55 times bigger than Allah. Yeah, Allah is very puny but sexy, brother. He has curly hair. He's a young man, but he's very tiny, brother. And he's sexy, and he knows it. Right? Very sexy, like Zakir Naik, brother. Sexy, and he knows it. Brother. Brother. I mean, this is amazing. Guys, is this a nuclear bomb or not? is this a nuclear bomb? Or, I mean, if the grandson of Adam is 55 times bigger than Allah, how dare you Muslims to say that Allah is Akbar? Allahu Akbar. No, you should say Auju Akbar, not Allah. Oh boy. Is there any Muslim who is not a troll? And maybe you can defend Muhammad. Any non-trolls? Guys, this is the... When I saw this, I was really shocked. I didn't know. I didn't know myself. And you see, there are many, many books that we need to read, many sources that we need to read to find such shocking facts. Allah turns out not to be the biggest one in Islam. Anyway, let us continue. A cutie pie. Allah is really very thirsty and he knows it, brother. Guys, I promised you in the beginning that we have to talk also about that interview of this Jordan Peterson. Jordan Peterson is a very famous YouTuber. He's an atheist and he had a conversation with this idiot here, Mimi Hijab, the golden shower boy. And the more he talked, the bigger the nose gets, like his other friend, his boyfriend, Ibn Fibin. The more they talk, the bigger the nose gets. I mean, guys, look at my Photoshop skills, man. The nose almost look as if it's real, right? Like Pinocchio. He's better than Pinocchio nose, brother. Yeah, the conversation happened, but Muslims are like their prophet. The more Muhammad talks, the more he does poo-poo. It's like his Muslim apologists of the day, right? Muhammad Hijab, he went and had the conversation with Jordan Peterson. This person, this Jordan Peterson, he doesn't know much about Islam. And certainly, he didn't care during that conversation to refute this liar and deceiver. Because Muhammad Hijab said, the Prophet is mentioned in Isaiah 42. According to this liar and deceiver, this long nose, this Pinocchio, his prophet, his satanic prophet is mentioned in Isaiah 42. Uh-oh. Rob, can you play the video clip, please? Yes, I can. Yes, I will. Let us listen to that conversation, guys. Small part of it. And see what happens next. This is Mimi Hijab, brother. Mimi Hijab. Okay, let's see what he said.
We would say that there are clear verses in the Bible.
Clear verses. Do you hear it? In the Bible, okay?
For example, we point to Isaiah 42:11. Mm-hmm. Where there indicates a new prophet that's going to come. And in fact, Isaiah 42:11 in particular is extremely important because it even specifies the region. It says it will be sent to the people of Kedar. Mm-hmm. And the people of Kedar, as in Genesis, Kedar was the son of Ishmael. And basically from him is the lineage of Muhammad, or the Arabs, if you like.
Prove it. Okay. This guy that you see here, this Mimi Hijab, is nothing but a liar and a deceiver. You heard it, right, guys? Now, did you notice something, guys? Lately, Muslims stopped going to Song of Solomon 5:16. They stopped going to Deuteronomy 18:18. Now they are stuck with Isaiah 42. Did you notice, guys? Now they are stuck with Isaiah 42. Have you noticed it lately, guys? They stopped going to Deuteronomy 18:18 because they know this is not about Muhammad. Because if Muhammad would have been alive in the time of Moses, Moses himself would have picked up stones, according to two verses later in 18:20, Moses himself would have picked up stones and throw stones at Muhammad for being a satanic prophet. Because remember, Muhammad delivered satanic verses and gave you two Sahih Hadiths, three Sahih Hadiths actually, that Muhammad delivered satanic verses and he prostrated to the idols. That day, Muhammad became a mushrik. So how is this about Muhammad How is this a prophet? If this is not enough, if this is not enough, if this is not enough, if this is not a huge hole in the standard narrative, let us go to the Quran, shall we? Muslims, watch carefully. Christians, take notes. If you go to Surah Al-A'raf, Ayah 157 of the Quran, look what it says. Who follow the messenger, the Gentile prophet. Now, if Muslims say this is about Muhammad, fine, I will go with you. What does it say next? The Gentile prophet, the illiterate prophet, the spiritually illiterate prophet, Muhammad, if you want to say this is about Muhammad, fine, I will go with your argument. I will go with your hujjah. Described in the Torah and the Gospel. Where? Where? Fit Tawrati wal Injili. Okay, I will go with you. Muslims, Yamimi Hijab, golden showers boy with your Pinocchio nose, that it keeps growing. According to the Quran, you must go to the Torah and the Injil. Christians and Muslims, is Isaiah 42 part of the Torah or the Injil? Again, is Isaiah 42 part of the Torah or Injil? The Quran says, go to the Torah and the Injil, you'll find Muhammad there. Is Isaiah in the Torah or Injil? No! So you see, Muhammad Hijab doesn't know his Quran, and he calls Allah and his prophet liars. So why do you go to Isaiah 42? Well, your Quran commands you to go to the Torah and the Gospel, because there you'll find Muhammad. If you want to say this is about Muhammad. You see how they don't even know their own Quran and call their prophet and Muhammad, their Allah liars? Huh? Uh-oh. You see how these illiterates, I like their prophet, bunch of illiterates. They cannot read and they can't understand their own Quran. So why do you go to Isaiah? Isaiah is not Torah. Isaiah is not Injil. Muhammad Hijab, you are a liar. You are even a fake Muslim and you're calling your own prophet and Allah and the Quran lies and deception. Liars and deceivers. Congratulations, Muhammad Hijab. You see, guys, how easy it is to expose these liars? Don't go to the Bible. Go to the Quran and use their own Quran against them. Why are you going to Isaiah and explain and take time? Furthermore, Muhammad Hijab said that Muhammad is from the lineage of Ishmael. He said it, right? Let us go back. Let us go back. Let us go back again. What did he say?
It says it will be sent to the people of Kedar, where there indicates a new prophet that's going to come. And in fact, Isaiah 42:11 in particular is extremely important because it even specifies the region.
Mm-hmm.
It says it will be sent to the people of Kedar. And the people of Kedar, as in Genesis, Kedar was the son of Ishmael. And basically, from him is the lineage of Muhammad.
Prove it. You disgusting liar, you deceiver. Since you are making this huge claim that Muhammad or the Arabs are from the lineage of Ishmael, I want you to prove it. Prove it. Abdul Aziz, yes?
You must remember.
Another, the same donkey, guys. Trigger the Abduls. Now, guys. Since he cannot prove it, let me prove it that he's a liar like his prophet. Let me prove that he is a liar like his prophet. If we go to the life of the Prophet Muhammad by Ibn Kathir, Asira Nabawiyah, guys, bear with me, guys, forget about these trolls. If we go to Asira Nabawiyah by Ibn Kathir, volume 1, Muslims are triggered, man. I understand that. It hurts. It hurts them so much And, you know, guys, imagine if they don't do this, if they don't troll. It means that I'm doing a really bad job. It means I'm doing a really great job today because I am triggering these pagans, these black stone-kissing pagans. They know we are spanking their prophet and their heroes, and they can't do anything about it. They can only troll. Bunch of trolls, man. I love this. Keep doing that, man. I love it. Now, if we go to page 51. Page 51 of Asira Nabawiya, Volume 1 by Ibn Kathir. We scroll down. Look. Let me help Muhammad Hijab and shake him out of his misery. Look. As Suhaili commented also that Malik's viewpoint was analogous to what was related of Urwa bin Zubair, who is reported to have said, Urwa bin Zubair, who is reported to have said, and I quote, "We have found no one," again, "we have found no one who knows the line between Adnan and Ishmael." Uh-oh. Nobody knows the links, the names between Adnan and Ishmael. Rob, what does that mean? Let us continue reading. It is reported that Ibn Abbas himself said, the cousin of Muhammad, the ink of the Ummah, the translator of the Quran, that Ibn Abbas said, between Adnan and Ishmael, there were 30 names, 30 ancestors, who are what? Unknown. Unknown. So, in other words, Muhammad Hijab just lied. He cannot prove that Muhammad or the Arabs, the Quraysh, that they are go back to Ishmael. That's a lie. You don't know it. You can't prove it. And we read, continue reading. We see Ibn Abbas also reputed to have said, when he traced back lines of descent, as far as Adnan, he said, and I quote, Ibn Abbas said, and I quote, the genealogists have lied twice or thrice. So they have lied. Like Muhammad Hijab, like the golden shower boy himself. You boy, you're a liar, like the genealogist who lied about the genealogy of Muhammad. You don't know the names. There are 30 missing names. They are unknown. And even Omar, the Caliph, Omar ibn al-Khattab, stated, read with me, Omar said, we carry back the genealogy only as far as Adnan. Oh boy. 30 missing names? They cannot trace back the genealogy of the Quraysh, the family of Muhammad, back to Ishmael? Yes, that's basically the whole point. No Muslim can give us evidence that Muhammad, here again, guys, look, in other words, if we put this in a diagram like this or a flowchart like this, we see this is Muhammad. We go back, this is his family. Look, his supposed mother, his John Doe father, Abdullah, his grandfather, Abdul Muttalib, but here comes the problem. You see, here's Adnan. Look, guys, here is Adnan. And between Adnan and Ishmael, there are 13 missing names. So the link is disconnected. There are 30 missing names here. So how can you say Muhammad or the Arabs or the Quraysh go back to Ishmael? That's a lie. The genealogists have lied. Wow! Bam! So stop lying. Muhammad Hijab, you're a liar. You're a deceiver. You cannot prove it. Back up what you say. Can you? I challenge any Muhammadan. I challenge any Muslim apologist. I challenge any Muslim scholar, any sheikh, to prove me wrong. I challenge you to back up what you say about your prophet. Back it up. 13 missing names between Adnan. Yeah. So guys, in other words, what is being said here, that they can only trace the family tree, the lineage back, only at Adnan. Do you see this here, this name here? It stops at Adnan. Poof. so they cannot prove that Muhammad or the Quraysh go back to Ishmael. It's a lie. Baseless claims. Claims that they cannot back up. Claims that they cannot back up with evidence. So stop lying to yourselves, Muslims. Stop lying to us. You see how Muhammad Hijab lied to Jordan Peterson during that interview? Bunch of liars. Any Muhammadan? Maybe you know better than Muhammad. Maybe you can help Muhammad Hijab. Yeah, Bill Shepard, do you see? they think that Adnan is the son of Ishmael, but no, there are 13 missing names between Adnan and Ishmael. So they can't prove that Muhammad is from Ishmael. Ishmael lived in Egypt. His sons lived in Jordan. Muhammad lives down south. What has Mecca and Medina to do with up north, with Jordan and Egypt? Nothing. Nothing in common. No names. Missing names. There you go. So do you see, guys? Here's another flowchart. Here is supposedly Abraham. Here is Ishmael. But we can put a huge red cross. This does not go back to Muhammad. Muhammad, Muslims cannot prove that Muhammad is from Ishmael. They cannot prove it. Missing names. 30 missing names. That's more than 1,000 years of names. More than 1,000 years of missing names. Do you see how this cult is nothing but a fabrication, guys? Islam is nothing but a fabrication, in other words. Do you see how easy it is? Just by doing some little research. Do you see how easy it is to spank Islam left and right? Proving that Islam is nothing but a pagan cult. Muhammad was a pagan. His father was a pagan. His mother was a pagan. His grandfather was a pagan. What has that to do with Abraham? Idiots. Stop lying. You cannot back it up. I can say I'm from the lineage of Santa Claus. Since Muhammad can make that claim, I can make that claim too. But where is my proof? Where is my evidence? Where is my backup? Right, guys? Pure lies. Only baseless claims. When you can't back it up, you're nothing but a liar. And even the Islamic books are saying that the genealogists have lied. Look, this is Ibn Abbas. He says, the genealogists have lied twice or thrice. They have lied about Muhammad. They have lied about the Quraysh. The Quraysh has nothing to do with Ishmael. Nothing but lies. And they have to confirm it. Rocky Balboa, call in and help your prophet out because I'm spanking your pagan, satanic prophet. And the only thing you can do is cry in my live chat. Rocky Balboa, can you give us a description? How does it feel to become my personal dhimmi? You are my personal dhimmi and you can only cry in my live chat. Be more man than Aisha and call me. Exactly, Living Hope. 13 generations missing. So it's nothing but a lie. They lied. It's in front of you. Take a screenshot. Again, this is Ibn Kathir's As-Sira Nabawiyyah, Volume 1, The Life of the Prophet Muhammad. Ibn Kathir, page 51. It's in front of you. Scroll down and you see the damage right there. The Ummah is drowning with the lies of the Muslims of today. Only blah, 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 blah. No evidence, no backup. And that's how the cookie crumbles, baby. That's how the cookie crumbles. Filthy liars, filthy deceivers. I wish I was there during that interview. I would have smacked Mimi Hijab left and right. I think Jordan Peterson was only, you know, listening to his lie. He knows he's a liar. He knows that his prophet is a liar, but maybe he was just, you know, enjoying the fun. Guys, keep all the truth seekers among the Muslims out there in your prayers. Like that sister who called us, that sister humanity, Sister Sammy, that Muslim lady who is in doubt. She's about to leave Islam, guys. Keep her in your prayers. Sister Sammy, keep her in your prayers. This lady, she in her heart, we know she left Islam, but she promised me to call me if she is out of Islam. So I hope I'll pray to my Creator, to my Lord and Savior Jesus Christ, for you to be saved. Continue doing your investigation. You took notes, you took screenshots, Sister Sammy. We love you. You are our sister in humanity. We only wish for you to accept the truth, to come back home to your Lord and my Lord Jesus Christ. Guys, I'm tired. I'm hungry. Let us wrap this up. Thank you for being here. Again, if you missed today's live show, you can rewatch it. It will take some time for the live chat to reappear again. All right? It takes some time. Our admins will provide the timestamps in a couple of hours and the references by Phil Herrera. So keep our admins in your prayers. Keep us, keep the warriors in your prayers, guys. If you want to support us financially, you can do that on patreon.com/robchristian. Thank you for being here. Keep me and my family in your prayers, guys. Our admins too. We are not doing this because we hate Muslims. Actually, it's the opposite. We love Muslims. You are our brothers and sisters in humanity. We want you to be saved. And again, every knee will bow. Every tongue will confess that Jesus is Lord. And Muhammad is nothing but a fraud, fake prophet. Thank you for being here, guys. God bless you. Deus vult. We will see each other very soon again in a future live show. God bless. Backup channel, please subscribe. Did you subscribe, guys?